This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here, and we'll give you the toll-free numbers and our Skype here in a moment to allow you to take control of the airwaves, bring up anything that you want to discuss. With you, joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Danica.
Rich Paul.
And we're going to actually start out tonight with a special guest, which we don't really have guests on the show very often. It is an open phone show, so we will certainly open the phones up after our guest. And if you do have a question for him, and actually two guests, I should say, from Cop Block, they are about ready to kick off another Cop Block tour that Free Talk Live and LRN.FM and Free Keen has sponsored in the past, many, many years ago, back not too long after we made the move here to New Hampshire. Ademo Freeman and Pete Ayer and some other guys went on tour, and they toured around. They did something called Liberty on Tour, and those eventually turned into Cop Block tours. And I've had the pleasure of being, you know, of helping them make this thing happen as a sponsor, and so I'm grateful to be on board again now that Cop Block is so much bigger than it was back in, when was it founded? 2008, Ademo Freeman? Welcome.
Well, 2010, January 2010, so we're approaching 6 years.
Yeah. Oh, wow. It seems like it's been longer than that.
Well, yeah, I guess, like, yeah, as you know, doing the grind, it takes some time, and so 6 years here in January will be January 24th-ish.
So you've actually teamed up with a guy named Brian Sumner, and tell me a little bit about Brian, and then let's talk about Cop Block and the tour.
Sure. Well, Brian is from Fresno, California, and was part of Fresno Cop Block, and this past January, I became more active again after a little bit of time doing an agorist business and clearing my head after doing some jail time. But when I came back to Cop Block this January, I started a thing called the Cop Block Network, which is basically trying to harness the energy of the decentralized nature of Cop Block by, you know, having all these folks who are active like Brian or Kelly Patterson or like folks that are up there in Keene to say, hey, we're all doing these things. Let's kind of do them with the same direction and see what happens. And since then, we have over 13 contributors at the website. The CopBlock.org is getting over 2 million hits a month. And
wow.
Now the CopBlock Network is also a large reason why Brian and I are able to take to the road for the next 7 months in MAC, the mobile accountability for cops.
I want to talk more about MAC and what your plan is on the road. But for our listeners who maybe are new to the show tonight, perhaps new to Cop Block, I mean, Cop Block has become an international phenomenon to encourage people to hold police accountable, usually with video cameras, but to, you know, hold cops accountable for their actions, one of the main goals of Cop Block. But can you explain what Cop Block is for a new listener tonight?
Sure. Well, Cop Block is the idea that badges don't grant extra rights. It's very simple. Many people with different varieties of freedoms or thoughts on other social issues still can unite under this idea for the police aspect that, like I said, badges do not grant extra rights. CopBlock.org is obviously a website. And through these two channels, folks are free to do, you know, like whatever they see is fit. Some folks will contribute to CopBlock.org through the Cop Block Network, make videos and do their own things. Other folks start their own chapters that have their own websites, their own Facebook pages. They have local meetups. They go out on like regular patrols. We hope to meet up with quite a few of those folks that are active throughout the Cop Block idea while we're on the road. And so, yeah, Cop Block is the idea that badges don't grant extra rights, and Cop Block is a decentralized organizations where folks can unite under that banner. To, you know, say, you know, let's get some accountability and some transparency.
And one of the ways you do that is by encouraging people to record video of the police. Like, it's one of the easiest things that you can do, although I guess some people would say it can be a little nerve-wracking the first time or few times out. That's definitely one of the tenets, right?
Oh, absolutely. The best tool is the video camera, and that's the start of a lot of these aspects, as well as sharing some ideas and tactics and networking with other folks. So you can get all of that at coplock.org/resources, where there's a number of tips for filming the police, gear you might need, apps that are good for your phones, even defense strategies into court, which, you know, many of us that are on the show here tonight are aware of, whether that's jury nullification, representing yourself, or Mark Stevens' approach of, you know, jurisdiction and legitimacy.
So this isn't your first rodeo. It's not your first tour. When was the last time you went on one of these things?
Well, 2012 is when I, you know, at the like beginning of 2012 is when Pete and I stopped touring Liberty on tour. Most of that was due to the number of legal cases I found myself in. I was facing the three wiretapping charges in New Hampshire there, Manchester. And so that was really occupying a lot of my time. And with that uncertainty, you know, I was facing 21 years in prison. So it was very hard to plan anything further than like the conclusion of that trial.
Yeah. And you were facing that time in prison because you recorded some government bureaucrats here in New Hampshire, where the laws against wiretapping are absolutely ridiculous. Some of the worst law on the books here in New Hampshire. And you managed to beat that at the Supreme Court.
That's right. It was ultimately overturned after I did 92 days in jail.
Right.
But
you didn't get those days back, though.
Nope, not at all. But so after that, I kind of took a little time off and tried to do like an agorist business with Sons of Liberty Mint. And I appreciated the time I spent there. And it was definitely, you know, in hindsight needed to like, you know, freshen my legs, take a new perspective on some things. And like I said, this, at the end of 2014, you know, I decided that, you know, Cop Lock is probably where I belong, where I should be. And I kind of, you know, I was helping Pete with his previous tour, the Police Accountability Tour. Pete Ayer, the co-founder of mm-hmm. CopLock.org with me, when him, Jacob Crawford, and Garrett Ian went on the road cross country. And so I was behind the scenes in that and involved in some of the other aspects. But in January, I came back, I guess, to be like creating content regularly, trying to expand the network of CopLock. So like getting some of the bloggers that were all sporadically blogging everywhere into one area, helping us promote one another. Mm-hmm. You know, we now have a relationship with libertystickers.com who provides us. Yeah. They provide us some great flyers and outreach materials, which gets back into the hands of these local chapters who are out on the street. So not only are they filming when somebody comes up and asks them, why are you doing this or whatnot? You know, you can't always have the A to Z conversation, you know, as in like, oh, I'm filming the police because of this. And then they understand it when they leave. So that now they have business cards or 3x5 flyers or what we call the warning flyer, which warns people of police activity in their area. All of those can be seen at coplock.org/flyers. And so that's what I've been doing in the last couple months. And that's all accumulated into the 13 contributors and now our 7-month tour, which we hope could conclude with a Coplock Network headquarters.
So you're going to be on the road for 7 months, traveling all around the 48 United States, right? The contiguous 48.
Yeah, primarily the Southwest at this time because of mm-hmm. the time of year it is.
Right. And you're kicking off from, you're in the Cincinnati area right now. You've got, as you said, MAC, which is the Mobile Accountability for Cops. Was that what it stood for? What was it?
Yep. Mobile Accountability for Cops is what MAC stands for.
And it's an RV. It's kind of like a little shorty, though, right? This isn't a monster RV like you had previously with your previous
Marv.
Tours. Marv. Yeah.
Marv, the mobile account or the mobile authority resistance vehicle.
You got to say it with the New York accent, Marv.
Marv. That's right. Marv was 30 feet long, and actually Mac is only 6 feet shorter.
Oh, really? Okay.
But I believe because of the cab being different, the Marv was a Class A, and Mac is a Class C, and so that means it has like the two doors in the front and like a cab where the driver and passenger can ride.
I see.
Mac is more square in front, or excuse me, Marv was more square in front, and so it probably looks, you know, that extra 6 feet looks a lot more when it's not squared off with the nose.
Right, right. All right. So there's enough room for the two of you in there comfortably. And, you know, you've done this before, but I know Brian's with you. Brian, have you ever been on anything like this before? Have you ever lived in an RV cross country?
Okay. So I've never lived in an RV across country, but I have lived in an RV before.
Oh, okay. Just stationary.
He's accustomed to some of the knickknacks, you know, like the dinette folds into the bed area as well. And so like these multi-use spaces.
I want to talk more, if you guys have time, about, you know, what the plan is. What are you guys going to be doing on the road? I know that you certainly will be recording the police and likely meeting up with people all around the country. And obviously, a big question is, where are you going first out of Cincinnati? And when is it going to kick off? All of that still to come. You guys can stick with us for a little bit, right?
That's right.
All right, more from copblock.org's tour.
We ran out. We stopped using it.
Why would you stop? Why undo all the good that's been accomplished?
We thought everything was fine, and that was not a good thing.
No.
He started stinking. It was awful.
Shedding comes back. Loss of hair, lots of dandruff.
Scratching will return. His shedding will increase.
If I ever took Roy off of Dinovite, he would go back to his hair loss.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dinovite,
when I get to about 3/4.
Oh no, I've got a couple more scoops.
It's time to place my order. Dinovite.com.
Each and every day she is getting that Dinovite.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dinovite. If it's working, don't quit.
Don't do what I did and run out.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
No! That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And you can talk about anything that happens to be on your mind. It doesn't have to be police accountability rated. How about related? Although I do have a police story from copblock.org that we can talk about, where a Florida officer of the year has been arrested on child porn charges.
Again,
there's no shortage.
Officers of the year. How do they pick them?
Yeah. So we can get into that. There's no shortage of these awful cop stories, and of course that's one of the things that copblock.org is really great at, is bringing them all to the same place. So if you like following police abuse and awful cop sort of nasty stories, there's no shortage at copblock.org. We also have Ademo Freeman and Brian Sumner with us here, and I want to return to them to talk more about the CopBlock tour that is about ready to kick off. But I also want you to know about how you can get Bitcoin and how you can get it very affordably through ExpressCoin. It is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, it's fast, safe, easy, and it's inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and you can get cryptocurrency with money order or check. Just get started at ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. They can likely help you get some Bitcoin over at ExpressCoin.com. You can do it from your smartphone. They've got an app. Plus, you can use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, and you'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. Just get started at ExpressCoin.com. And don't forget coupon code FTL. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
Danica.
Rich Paul.
All right, let's go back to Ademo and Brian, who are preparing to take off from the Cincinnati, Ohio area to various different parts of the United States, starting with the Southwest. Ademo, when are you guys going to kick this tour off? I've heard next week. What's the plan? Where are you guys at?
Well, we've kind of kicked it off a little bit already. Last weekend, we went into Cincinnati. We're just on the outskirts and covered a protest that was in the name of Samuel DeBose, who was shot and killed by the University of Cincinnati Police Department. And that officer has since been indicted and is going to be heading to trial. But some arrest and an excessive use of a taser happened there. And our footage from that incident has been getting some pretty good media attention around here. So it's partially kicked off already. It was a good Saturday for us to get out. We've been working in Mac a lot on these logistics. But I really think Brian and I will gel really well. And it was nice to have that little kick before we even started. Run. Right. But tomorrow we head to another friend's shop. We're going to, unlike other tours, be towing a car along. We'll be bringing my car, which will give us a wider range of areas to cover, because when we were in Marv, that 30 footer driving that around anywhere is kind of an inconvenience. And mm-hmm. So we're going to be much more mobile this time having the car. We're going to go get some mounts put on that tomorrow. And then Sunday, start making our way north towards Chicago, where another CopBlock Network contributor, Ryan Scott, is, and he's just outside of Chicago in a college town, and we'll hold a little cop blocking night while we're there. It's one of like our pre-stops, because we're gonna spend about a month in each city. Whoa. But we will stop at some places along the way. So the first like big stop is Dallas, Texas, but we will hit just outside of Chicago, Iowa City, Kansas City, and Oklahoma City on our way there for like weekend cop blocking night. So folks can head over to copblock.org/MAC, not only get an overview of our schedule, keep up with the content we've created, and find out ways that they can help support our tour or content, the idea that badges don't grant extra rights as well.
Yeah, you guys are, you made a video that I saw you upload to YouTube wherein one can donate very small amounts to, up to $100. And there's T-shirts and goodies and things like that that you'll be shipping out as well. So you're going to be fulfilling orders while you're on the road, huh?
Well, yeah, for that donation aspect, we will be. Through the copblock.org/store, which has a number of other items that we don't have on Mac here.
Right.
Like bumper stickers, CopBlock stickers, the business cards and flyers, which you can get for free at copblock.org/flyer. But you can also buy them 100 at a time. And the proceeds go to get more flyers at copblock.org/store. So for the donation thing, the tour is funded. The advertisers like yourself and others have helped purchase the RV and get us down the first way. The CopBlock Network provides us a salary, but there are some variable expenses. And so if folks want to help us, with a meal or some gas in the tank, because state to state, city to city, that varies, mm-hmm. and season to season, they can go to copblock.org/Mac. They'll see the donation aspect there. And right now we're offering like CopBlock T-shirts, stickers, and even really cool $120 value smartphone cases. So you can get an OtterBox or LifeProof case for your smartphone up to $120 value if you donate $100 to the tour.
So what am I missing? I mean, what's going to be really cool about this that you know, we haven't talked about yet? Obviously, going from place to place. One question I had for you. You mentioned you're going to be staying for a month in major cities like Dallas, Texas. That means you're digging deep. You're not just, you know, coming in for a weekend, doing a little cop blocking and moving on. You're going to be in there and, like, investigating police corruption, right? Like, what are you going to be doing with your month's time? That's a long time.
Well, we have a number of ideas of things we can do. So, of course, we're going to cop block and hold events and try to talk to folks. But, you know, we also want to be repetitive, you know, so like we can go out several times after we meet folks. We can network with them to even cover local stories or make, you know, different types of content, whether that's like not so much cop blocking, but like we have a green screen on board, many cameras. We can do, you know, storytelling, tips, how to's, check out other people's gears, talk about their ways to combat police brutality or lack of accountability in their area. So a number of things, from embedding ourselves with offshoots, creating our own original content, and mixed in with the what everyone knows we do well, cop blocking on the streets.
And folks can keep an eye on the tour by going to copblock.org/Mac, and then also subscribing to the Cop Block YouTube channel or the Ademo Freeman YouTube channel. What's the best way to keep an eye on things?
Well, we have a Mac YouTube channel as well. Sadly, we don't have enough subscribers yet, but if you will find the link at copblock.org/Mac, and then we'll have a short URL for that.
Okay.
Also the Cop Block Network Facebook page, as well as copblock.org and its usual social networks. You know, everybody's things can feed through there, and so ours will as well.
Cool. All right. So is there anything that I've missed as far as, you know, covering what's happening here?
I think that's it. We hope that if we're on our stop, if we're in your area, that you come out to our meetup and or Cop Block with us, strength in numbers. And we can all learn things from one another, which is another big aspect to this. It's strengthening the network, providing people with the information to know, like, what is available to them through the Cop Block network and what they're doing in their area, so that we can, you know, work to spread the message that badges don't grant extra rights take it to the next level.
Any plans on coming back to the birthplace for a while?
Well, this tour is ridden out through April of next year. And so winter, obviously, which is why we're in the Southwest, because we're in an RV. But after that, we all know of the Free State Project's Pork Fest, the Porcupine Freedom Festival, held every June. Brian and I both have intentions of making it to that. And so I don't see why from, like, you know, May to July or August, there might not be a tour that starts in the middle of the country and heads to the Northeast.
Sounds like fun. And I know you're going to be keeping us in the loop here on Free Talk Live, and at least hopefully a weekly basis, kind of giving us updates and the latest.
That's our plans.
I appreciate it, you guys. Drive safe out there, and we'll look forward to hearing from you again. That's copblock.org/Mac. Go and follow those guys. Ademo and Brian are about to kick off the Cop Block Tour for 2015. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You can join us on Free Talk Live.
Open your mouth and say, ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue, and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at patriotnecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
Patriotnecklace.com?
Patriotnecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog egg chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from patriotnecklace.com.
A meme is not easy to define.
What is it?
But you know it when you see it.
Amazing.
Don'tTreadOnMeme.com proves that.
I feel so enlightened.
Don't Tread on Meme, M-E-M-E, helping you give the finger to our monetary system of deception by providing you with silver dime trading cards. Unlike today's dollar, they have value, and they look neat too.
Well, would you look at those? Aren't those just swell?
Don'tTreadOnMeme.com. While you're browsing their numerous silver dime card designs, take time to download the easy-to-use Silver Calculator app. This simple piece of technology lets you know instantly, whether using iPhone or Android, just how much your silver coin is worth. Find out all the details at DontTreadOnMeme.com. Now accepting Bitcoin. Don't Tread on Meme, your path to a voluntary society with honest money. DontTreadOnMeme.com, serving you faster than the Fed prints money.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you are invited to join us here on the radio waves. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. Whether you want to talk about the police, holding them accountable, or whatever happens to be on your mind, you may do so. 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Skype on in here at username lrn.fm in the studio with you. It's Ian.
Danica.
And Rich Paul. Hi, Rich.
Hi.
Paying too much attention to your smartphone over there.
Yeah, I was looking up that article on the Uber driver in Portsmouth.
Oh, yeah. Well, we'll definitely talk about the latest on the Uber civil disobedience driver. That's who you're referring to. The man in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, who is publicly announcing that he is ignoring the government's demands for jumping through their licensing hoops, their regulatory hoops, and he is illegally driving for Uber, and he hasn't been stopped by Uber yet, which is great news, and we'll give you the latest on his story here in a moment. But I also wanted to get into the story about this. Since we were talking about Cop Block, we were talking to Ademo Freeman and Brian Sumner, who are kicking off the Cop Block tour at copblock.org/MAC, M-A-C. I got a story from Cop Block here, and there's no shortage of these stories. This is just a recent one, posted 2 days ago by Stephen Thomas. Port St. Lucie officer Michael Harding was arrested Tuesday evening after Homeland Security investigators found child pornography on his Kick Messenger app. Now, I don't know what a Kick Messenger is.
Not heard of it, no.
But anyway, I imagine it's one of the myriad of messaging apps. As it turns out, the 27-year-old married father of three had posted the child porn while inside his police cruiser while on patrol. Officer Harding was uploading the explicit material to a Kick chat room called Pound Toddler FU. No need to spell the rest of it out. An investigator with the Homeland Security accidentally stumbled onto some posts made by Harding under his online name, which is Des the Above, which showed underage girls performing sex acts with men. The investigator determined the IP address with the uploads belonged to Harding's cell phone number. Later, a search of Harding's home turned up a thumb drive that was hidden in a gun case inside of his bedroom. The drive contained hundreds of child porn images and videos. Another thumb drive was found, but the images had been deleted. Techs were able to recover the deleted images, which contained more than 23 sexually explicit pictures, in addition to the hundreds on the other thumb drive. The images in that particular case were of preschool and prepubescent boys and girls. This is like this is actual child porn, right? Like we've talked about the teenagers who've been arrested for taking pictures of themselves naked or, you know, taking pictures of themselves in some sort of sex act. I don't consider that to be child porn because they're not children, right? Like the difference between a child and a teenager is very, very, you know, pronounced. One has gone through puberty, the other not so much. And, you know, so this is real child porn and it's pretty sick.
And of course, if in an actual selfie, there's no question of anything involuntary being involved.
Correct.
You know, I know.
No one put a gun to the 16-year-old's head and forced him to take a picture of himself naked in the mirror.
Exactly. Yeah. I know a lot of hippies that run around naked in the woods with their family, and that doesn't bother me. As a matter of fact, like, I've never seen my parents naked, and I have absolutely no desire to. But I think if I had grown up in an environment where I had, then I would be maybe it might be a little easier for me to deal gracefully with nudity. So
yeah, I tend to agree with you there.
So the Kick Messenger, I just quickly looked it up. It's, you know, an app like a lot of the other tween apps that are going around,
like a Snapchat,
and people have, it's been reported that people have been using it to swipe naked pictures back and forth, which is what sometimes
That's
Snapchat
what
gets used
do.
For. And it will be used with virtually any other kind of.
So the Snapchat gimmick is that the Snapchat goes away, supposedly.
Theoretically, but you can take screenshots
right.
of it.
Because there's apps that allow you to screenshot.
Well, you
right?
can also screenshot from your phone. And the funny thing about Snapchat is that if I were to screenshot a snap that someone sent me, they get a notification. The other person gets a notification that I've screenshotted it.
That's if you use Snapchat to screenshot. Aren't there
Correct,
other
yeah.
screenshot programs you can use?
I'm sure there are, but if you're just screen capping it from your phone, then it will send a notification.
I think on newer versions of Android, swiping three fingers across your screen will screenshot it without installing any app.
So
that's how my phone is. I've got an HTC.
Ah, okay. Well, HTC is a little different because they do their own custom sort of operating system overlay.
Well, that's why I included
well, the
that,
default
so your
screenshotting,
mileage may vary.
The default screenshotting for Android has always been the volume and the power button held down together
oh, really?
to do that, yeah.
Okay, see, I have installed at some point a screenshot program. I didn't know that they had it built into
they
the system.
They have it built in, yeah.
That
and
may be
iPhone's
a newer,
the same thing.
That may be a newer feature, but there are screenshotting programs
oh, yeah,
as well.
Oh, yeah, definitely. And there's, you know, independent Snapchat programs that you can install that will allow you to do more filters or more things, also have an easier way of keeping your snapshots.
So I guess
together.
My question is, what's different between what makes Kick different from the Snapchat?
I think Kick has more messaging abilities, whereas Snapchat will allow you to message somebody, but
it's
kind
more
of
for pictures.
It's more
and
for
video.
Pictures. It's not really heavily emphasized on text.
So Officer Harding here was taken to federal court hearing in Fort Pierce, where he was formally charged with sending and receiving child pornography, which is a minimum of 5 years, maximum of 20, in prison. Officer Harding was denied bond, with the judge saying that he is a danger to the public. I'd like to remind you that Officer Harding was the Officer of the Year in Port St. Lucie. Port St. Lucie Police Chief John Bolduc said that Officer Harding has been on paid leave since he became aware of the investigation, but that now he is on unpaid administrative leave pending the outcome of his trial. He was named Fort Pierce Police Officer of the Year in 2011 and joined the St. Lucie Police Department in 2012. And ironically, Officer Harding received a letter of appreciation from the Juvenile Restorative Justice Initiative. And I think that this, you know, story, while it's not the first one of its kind, he's not the first cop who's been busted with some kind of child pornography. But it, you know, it should give you pause. If you are the kind of person who believes that the police are out to help you and to protect you and to look out for your kids, well, you better be careful, because just because somebody's wearing a badge doesn't mean that you should be trusting your children with them.
Mm.
That brings up a really good argument that I love using, that say someone goes to school wearing a gun and, the parents of the children say, oh, we don't want that person to be around our kids. They have a gun. And like, okay, you're okay with a cop being around your kid because they've got a gun too.
Yeah, and the cops are probably more likely than the average people to actually use a gun to kill somebody.
Sure. Frankly.
Especially officers of the year. I mean, if officer of the year was a Superman, he was a superhero, it'd be like Florida Man. Are you familiar with Florida Man?
Florida Man is a reference to all of the various ridiculous Florida stories, correct?
They've determined that this is actually just one guy. He's a superhero named Florida Man, and he flies around doing insane things and shifting forms. And Officer of the Year seems to be the same sort of thing going on, where, you know, if the headline starts Officer of the Year, it's not going to end well.
And this was in Florida, so maybe it was Florida Man.
Have been Florida Man.
Right. So no, I had not heard about Florida Man. That was new to me. I just sort of heard of it in the term of, like, there's ridiculous news stories about Florida Men, but
there's actually a couple of Florida Man
superhuman thing.
Websites now, I believe.
That's awesome. So if you want to share your thoughts here, toll-free number 855-450-FREE. I mean, there's really not much you can say about this besides, obviously, this dude's a sicko, and watch your kids around cops. You know, you don't know who these people are. Just because they're a cop doesn't mean they're trustworthy or good.
No.
So you can share your thoughts with us here. You can also join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Coming up, one man shares his experience at truthvoice.com that he writes, how my first arrest changed my opinions of police.
Ooh.
And I suspect that being arrested for the first time will have a tendency to do that for folks. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live. Join us.
It's finally fall, a time for cooler temperatures and hot deals from America's Best Value Inn. Save 20% when you book a room online at abvi.com by October 15th and stay two or more consecutive nights now through October 22nd. Plus, you'll enjoy free continental breakfast, internet, and instant rewards through our Value Club at most of our 1,000 hotels in North America. Into savings this season at America's Best Value Inn.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at SilverLungs.com. That's SilverLungs.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand Minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. Joining you in studio, Ian here.
Danica.
Rich Paul.
And you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Check out Rich. More Rich Paul available for you on the Church of the Invisible Hand, which is at this time a Facebook page, but at some point it may be more than that.
Yeah, I mean, we've got web hosting now. We just need to get the domain name registered and... We'll have a WordPress site up.
You've got a lot of cool stuff that you're doing with the church, and you recently did a wedding that was actually accepted. The paperwork was accepted by the state, so that's going to help legitimize the Church of the Invisible Hand. What's the kind of the pitch for listeners? What is the Church of the Invisible Hand?
Well, the Church of the Invisible Hand is descended from deism, which was the religion of several of the founding fathers. Mm-hmm. So it's actually a variant of a well-established church. And
a deist belief is that God sort of like set it and forget it, basically.
Yeah, exactly.
It has absolutely no impact on anything else.
Exactly. So God, the way I put it is, if you take Stephen Hawking's event horizon that occurred at the Big Bang, Stephen Hawking says you can't. There's no way to find out what's behind the Big Bang. There's no information, and that's called an event horizon in physics. The same sort of thing they used to think happened with black holes, but now they're not so sure. But so the deist God exists only behind the event horizon. He's not observable from our universe. You can call him; he ain't gonna do nothing. And the Church of the Invisible Hand actually isn't entirely sure that he exists. Just a matter, we're actually agnostic. We make no statement as to the nature of existence of God, but we do not believe that he does anything within our universe that is observable. And so therefore we believe in self-reliance, and we believe that the best way to find out the nature of the universe is to look at the evidence around you. And the idea of agnosticism for me goes beyond there is no God. It also goes on to say, be careful of how sure you are about things. Mm-hmm. I mean, the Greeks had a very elaborate system of their four elements that turned out to be utter nonsense. It was meaningless, but they worked very hard on it. And somebody had to let go of that idea for it to fade away and be replaced by truth.
Our toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Again, more Rich Paul. Go look for him at the Church of the Invisible Hand on Facebook. Let's go to Dean, calling from Canada via Skype. Hello, Dean.
Good evening. How are you guys doing?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Good. I just thought I'd give a little bit of an update on my run for office here. I'm running for Parliament in Ottawa.
there's a big push. You called like a week or two ago to tell us about this, that in Canada this year, the Libertarian Party is really throwing a lot of candidates at the elections.
Yeah, that's
right.
Got a
Libertarian.
We are just coming up on the deadline to register candidates, and we've been seeing a lot of our candidates get registered. I just officially got registered the other day, which was quite a relief because I have been hearing some stories from members of the party that the election officials have really been scrutinizing the paperwork and giving them a hard time on things like signatures. But I didn't have any issues, so I'm all registered. I did have an interesting experience this week with participation in a debate hosted at the university campus at the university that I attend. One of the student associations that represents students who live on campus hosted a debate, and I really didn't not receive an invitation and only heard about it about a week before it happened. So I tried to, I made lots of effort to get in contact with the organizers, and they were really quite, really kind of dodging me about whether I'd be able to participate. And 24 hours before it was scheduled to happen, they said, "We're only going to let the big parties participate in the debate."
Boo.
So, I did put up a little bit of a fight. They still weren't budging. They wouldn't even allow me to make an opening and closing statement before and after the debate. So I went out and I made some flyers and started handing them out on campus, letting the students who are supposed to be represented by this organization know just how much this organization cares that they are able to make a fully informed vote. That made the administration pretty uncomfortable, I think. And ended up being able to broker a deal with the help of some members of the Conservative Party on campus. And I did end up being able to make a brief statement at the beginning and the end of the debate. But I will be participating in another debate on campus next week.
Cool. Congrats.
Well, I'm glad to hear that's happening. And if you ever see a need I realize you're in Canada, so things aren't exactly the same, but there was a case in the University of Michigan where somebody brought somebody in to speak against, it was a libertarian student group, brought in a speaker to speak against affirmative action, and they got their budget pulled because it was supposedly too political. Well, they looked up and found the same college had sent people to the Supreme Court, had paid for people to go to the Supreme Court and protest outside in favor of affirmative action as part of a student group. And they actually sued and won.
Wow.
And got, now I'm not a big fan of taking money from the government, but if one political group is getting it, then we should all have equal access. And I think there might be a case like that in your debate story there.
Well, I mean, these are essentially government institutions, and they should be treating people fairly.
Yes.
And another, the reason I really tried to push so hard about this is because, yeah, this is an organization, it's a student-run organization, but they're meant to represent the students who live on campus. And I'm sure they didn't consult with any of the students before they made this decision. Another thing that's of note is that this same organization had just spent a whole bunch of money on an ad campaign with a big ad agency to try to encourage students to vote and to get involved in the electoral process. And it's, I think, very relevant since I'm the only candidate in this election who's actually a student at the university where the debate took place. I'm the youngest candidate, and they didn't want me to participate.
It's ridiculous. Hey, thanks for the update, Dean, and appreciate your call tonight. You can join us, as he has done, on our Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. We got Dan. He is calling from Pittsburgh, and I don't know if that's in Pennsylvania. Dan, where are you tonight? Dan? Dan in Pittsburgh, going once. Dan in Pittsburgh.
Yep.
Hello, we have you.
Hey, yes, it is Pennsylvania.
All right, go ahead with your thoughts.
So, yeah, I got a speeding ticket a week or two ago, and I'm taking it to court, and I wanted to just tell the story real quick and ask if you had any advice.
We don't do advice. We're not attorneys, but you're welcome to tell your story, and we can talk about it.
We'll give opinions, certainly.
All right. I've seen some of your court videos on YouTube, Ian, and they're pretty fascinating. Well, they're kind of boring, but they're just fascinating
court,
to see how how everything goes down. So yeah, so the main thing is that the speed limit was 35. It was going through a small town, and the cop told me 51. And so whatever, we did the stop and everything. I was about ready to just pay it. And I looked at the ticket. It says 51 miles per hour, but it also says the distance that he clocked me over and the time, because he was a local cop, just used a stopwatch. And so just for fun, I figured I'd do the math.
Right.
And
because speed is distance over time.
Right, right. And it came out to 41, not 51.
Wow.
This will be a fun court case.
Yeah, so I'm kind of wondering, first of all, do you think that they'll accept that? Or do you think they'll be like, well, there's nothing we can do? It says that, like, if a ticket says two completely different things, do they have any choice but to just throw it out? Can they change it or something and just say, oh, well, he probably just miswrote that? I don't know. And also, that and how much do you think I have to show them how the math works? I figured I could print out a little, you know, high school algebra equation and stuff, but
hold that thought, Rich.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Well first off, what exactly was the speed limit where you were?
35.
It was 35.
Okay, so that would put you six over. Well first off, certainly you could fight it on the basis that the math was wrong. And moreover, I would say that if his work was that sloppy on doing the math, who knows what else he got wrong? Has he ever even been properly trained to do this? So I would attack,
right.
You want to attack his information, which is obviously wrong.
He's not credible.
Exactly. That kind of destroys his credibility with me.
An extremely unprofessional stopwatch.
Yeah, stopwatch. I mean, what police department can't afford a radar
gun?
Are we at
track and field or something?
Well, maybe they can't afford it because people keep beating their tickets.
I don't know how it is nationwide, but in Pennsylvania, only state cops can use radar.
Hold that thought, Dan. I want to come back and talk about this further if you've got time. This is Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, September 25th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.08 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,144 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238.
Antiwar.com reports over the weekend, local officials reported that Syria's government and al-Qaeda had reached yet another ceasefire in the city of Zabadani and the Idlib villages of Fua and Kafraya. Unlike previous weekend ceasefires, this was to be an open-ended deal. The ceasefire appears to have led to further delay on Thursday, with the two sides agreeing to mutual evacuation from the area. Under the agreement, al-Qaeda will be allowed to withdraw its fighters from Zabadani and Idlib, and they'll let some 10,000 civilians from Fua and Kafraya flee from Idlib into governmental territory. Fua and Kafraya are Shiite villages and were left surrounded by al-Qaeda after recent military losses in the province. Zabadani is surrounded by Hezbollah fighters who are trying to drive al-Qaeda out of the area along the Lebanese border. Interestingly, while the agreement effectively turns Zabadani over to the Hezbollah-led forces, it does not allow pro-Syrian militias to withdraw from Fua and Kafraya, meaning the villages will remain under government control, albeit without any civilian population. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports Republicans in the U.S. House of Representatives will hear a proposal Friday that would strip federal funding for Planned Parenthood, but avoid the government shutdown that looms over the issue, according to sources. House Speaker John Boehner is pitching the strategy, which would fast-track the move against the organization and put it on President Obama's desk without having to risk a shutdown. The strategy will be discussed Friday in a closed-door meeting. Boehner's motive with this strategy is to satisfy the 30 GOP House members who are willing to risk a shutdown if the stripping of Planned Parenthood is not attached to a critical spending bill. However, Bloomberg Politics reported Thursday some in the House may consider challenging Boehner's leadership. The current spending arrangement expires September 30th. The Senate is planning to submit a new spending bill which would fund the government through December 11th. However, analysts say Boehner's plan might not work because Obama would likely veto the bill stripping Planned Parenthood, and Republicans don't have enough votes in the Senate for an override.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a U.S. Border Patrol agent has been indicted for murder in a cross-border shooting of a Mexican teenager in 2012 in what an attorney for the victim's family on Thursday called an unprecedented move. A federal grand jury on Wednesday indicted agent Lonnie Schwartz for second-degree murder in the October 10, 2012 shooting death of 16-year-old Jose Antonio Elana Rodriguez. Elana Rodriguez was shot through a fence separating the cities of Nogales, Arizona, where Schwartz was on patrol, and Nogales, Mexico, where the teen was walking. Officials have said Ilana Rodriguez was throwing rocks over the border fence at the agents. He was shot multiple times in the back, according to Louis Parra, an Arizona attorney who is representing the family in a civil suit filed last year. Parra said to his knowledge it was unprecedented for a Border Patrol agent to be charged with murder in a cross-border shooting. He said Schwartz has since been suspended without pay and ordered to turn in his weapon and his badge. Attorney Sean Chapman, who is representing Schwartz, was unavailable for comment on Thursday. Representatives for U.S. Customs and Border Protection could not be immediately reached. A union representing Border Patrol agents across the western United States spoke out against the charges on Thursday in a post on the union website. The union asked that the public withhold judgment while the criminal case plays out and said Schwartz is innocent. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Florida officials announced today its plan to experiment with new 600-lever voting machines.
The machine operates through a very straightforward process that we think is going to give Floridians the peace of mind that their votes will be counted. The voter turns on the machine using these 30 levers at the top and then enters their names and social security numbers using the alphanumeric levers near the bottom here. Right about now, the voter's going to have to find the two levers on the machine that are exactly identical and pull them at the same time. Then they're going to have to...
The new 22-foot-tall steam-powered machines, which officials are hailing as, quote, the future of voting, each feature over 45 separate panels of levers, along with an intricate series of valves, knobs, cranks, and pumps, all designed to streamline the electoral process.
Now, some of this may seem confusing, but every voter will be given a comprehensive 2,200-page manual when they enter their precinct that will explain exactly what to do.
This is the Onion News Network.
We are Free Talk Live. You can join the show by dialing in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, the executive of a major retail chain who doesn't give a damn that you know he smokes weed. And I found this one on your Facebook page, Rich Paul, so we'll talk about this guy. You might recognize him from the television. I'll not say more about who it is here in a moment, but it is Ian, Danica, and Rich. We actually still have Dan with us in Pittsburgh. For those of you just tuning in, Dan received a speeding ticket, and he's wanting to go to court on this one because, well, first of all, it's a good thing to just clog the court system with a bunch of victimless crimes, so it makes their life more difficult. But also, in this case, it looks like the officer really botched it up. He was apparently using a stopwatch.
A stopwatch, of all things.
And then measuring the distance over time, which is how you calculate speed, that somebody was, in this case, Dan, was driving. So he went past point A and then past point B, and the officer clocked him between point A and point B, wrote down that information about the distance and the time, and then messed up the division. The officer got 51 miles an hour, I believe, but the actual division is 41. The correct answer would have been 41 miles an hour in a 35-mile-an-hour zone. Did I recap that correctly, Dan, in Pittsburgh?
Yeah, yep, that is correct. Now, a couple things. In Pennsylvania, only state cops can use radar. So actually, all the local cops use just lines on the road and stopwatches. And the other thing is, on this stopwatch, because he wrote the model number down, I looked it up, you can input a distance, and it's supposed to do the math for you and just output the speed. And so I'm kind of at a loss. I feel like it just has to be a miswrite or something. I don't know. But
yeah, he definitely screwed something up. Now, you had asked about when you go to trial how to approach this. Now, I'm not an attorney. This isn't legal advice. But here's the way I would do it if it were me. I wouldn't mention anything about the screw-up until Officer So-and-so is on the stand under oath and is being cross-examined by you. And then at that point, you can do something where you kind of catch him in his mistake, you know, say, "Officer, can you tell me how, you know, what was the speed that you said that I was going?" 51 miles an hour. Okay, and you said that it was, you're certain about that, correct? Yeah, I am absolutely certain about that. And you're certain about the numbers, the other ones, like the distance and the time.
Right.
Like, you know, get him to lock it in that he's absolutely certain that that was what you were doing. And then you can say, "Officer, can I give you this calculator here and have you go ahead and, you know, do the division and tell us what that number is?" You could try that or something, you know, to that effect, mm-hmm. where you actually get him to say on the stand that his numbers were inaccurate. And then you could perhaps motion to dismiss based on the witness is essentially unreliable.
If it were me, right, I would actually first just ask him to do the math in his head. Oh, okay, you can't do that. Would you like a calculator?
Yeah.
Give him the calculator and then say, "Did you have a calculator with you in the car?" Because then he's kind of pointed out that he can't do the math without the calculator. Now,
okay.
That... don't know exactly how your stopwatch they had worked was. The other thing that I would point out is if he's doing it off a stopwatch, then say he's measuring you over a quarter a mile, he's got to be able to accurately say from a quarter mile away when you cross that line. And that's an error-prone process, and he's kind of ruined his ability to say, I don't make mistakes, I'm a cop.
Right.
Which, actually, the proper answer is if you think you don't make mistakes, you're a narcissist. But anyway, go ahead.
Yeah, the thing is, too, it wasn't a quarter mile. It was like 150 feet. And so
the shorter the distance, the more inaccurate it's going to be, right?
Like, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, the other thing is you can do the experiment they used to do in physics class where they would you would hold your hand at the bottom of a ruler. Somebody else would hold it up and drop it. And as soon as you see it moving, you catch it. Okay, and the distance between catching it and dropping it and catching it, the distance in the difference in distance can then give you, you can calculate the reaction time from that. And, you know, that reaction time is usually a couple of seconds. And if he's measuring you over 150
feet
at, you know, either 41 or 51 or some number of miles an hour that he's incapable of calculating, then I don't see how he could do that with any regularity. And if you can beat them well, you might well create a precedent there, because if they're all doing it, they're all engaged in a terribly inaccurate process.
I think the stopwatch itself is enough to get thrown out. It's just like, I can't take you seriously. I can't take you seriously with the stopwatch. Like, this is law enforcement, not a track and field meet.
Motion to dismiss. Once he, you know, once you catch him in his mistake, you can motion to dismiss because the witness is incompetent to testify. And that's a common objection. That's an actual legal objection. You know, they're probably not going to let you get away with it. Like you said, they can just change the numbers and, you know, they can update the complaint. But
Can change the numbers. But what's the number? What's the evidence?
Yeah.
Right.
I mean, the evidence is that he wrote this down at the moment when it was fresh and he got it wrong. So changing a number on a ticket doesn't make that ticket right.
I think you've got a good argument here, Dan. I think that you could possibly beat this. Technical question, though, about challenging things, because in some states or some localities, they actually charge you money to go to court in addition to what, you know, the fine might actually be. Do you know if there are court costs involved in Pittsburgh?
So, yeah, I had to put up like a $9. Well, no, the price of the ticket plus $9 for fees. So I would imagine that I won't get that back if I'm innocent. But if that's it, it's $9 or something. So
if you go to court and you beat this, let's say that you motion to dismiss and the case gets dismissed based on, you know, the witness screwed up, so he can't be trusted in the case, does that mean you get the $9 back and the full speeding ticket amount back?
Right. That's what I'm not sure about. I'm not sure about the $9, but I should get $180 or something back. So,
yeah, see, they do this in some places where you actually have to pay the full amount, which is what you did, up front in order to even secure your supposed right to a trial, which I think is absolutely outrageous. And I'm grateful they don't do that here in New Hampshire. In New Hampshire, you just simply challenge the case, you go to trial, and then once you're found guilty, then you have to pay them. Or you can do community service in a lot of cases. But if they've already got their hands on your money, it's going to be very, very hard. Let's say you get found guilty. It would be very hard to get them to agree to community service after they already have the $180 in their bank account.
Right, yeah.
You know, so it really screws you from, you know, it's very disenfranchising, I think, from the system to do that to people. Dan, will you do us a favor and let us know how it goes?
Yeah, sure thing.
Cool, man. Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate the story. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. In a lot of places, I wouldn't really recommend doing this whole take it to trial thing if it's going to cost you more to do that. In some places, there's court fees can be in the hundreds of dollars. He said it was just $9 in that particular case. In Florida, I had a friend who was going to court for a DUI, and I got to see some of the paperwork, and it showed me on the paperwork what the court fees were. And it was literally in the hundreds, like $200 to $300 for court fees, which is crazy. And that's a huge disincentive
to challenge a case.
It is a disincentive, but it's probably still an underestimate of their actual cost in dealing with things. And the thing is, maybe. I might well pay the extra $9 because they've got to have attorneys and judges yep. and courtrooms and lights and bailiffs, and all that sure. stuff adds up. So, you know, if you can cost your enemy more than you cost yourself, it might not be a bad thing to do, especially if you go in. I'd like to learn this whole challenge jurisdiction thing just so I could do that. No, but I'd like to go in and do it before my actual defense, just to confuse them.
855 450 free. What do you want to talk about? Court or whatever happens to be on your mind. You can join us here. And if you've got a suggestion for Dan, by no means are we legal experts. If you've got a suggestion for his case, feel free to share it. 855 450 free. This is Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll free. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features that are waiting for you there. You get to create the content right there on the front page of the website. So enjoy freetalklive.com. Coming up October 29th and 30th, Vegas is the place for the very first ever Bitcoin Investor Conference. Our very own Mark Edge will be there broadcasting live with Free Talk Live. And there'll be all kinds of Bitcoin movers and shakers that you can meet and talk to. Trace Mayer, Stephanie Murphy, Tone Vase, Paul Pui, Joseph von Perling, Bitcoin Bell, Stephen Michaels, Edward C. May, and more. Go to bitcoininvestor.com and get your tickets now. That's bitcoininvestor.com. It's October 29th and 30th. It's happening at the D Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada. And the D Hotel takes Bitcoin. So go to bitcoininvestor.com, and Mark will be seeing you there. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We can talk more about court techniques and tactics here in a moment, how to clog the system. But first, we go to Peed Off in New York. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian Danica and Rich Paul. Hello? Hello? Peed Off calling from New York.
It is me, Dave. How are you guys doing?
I called it, didn't I?
Yes,
I
said this was going to
be called it.
Yeah, I said this was going to be Dave. All right, Dave, what's up?
Jonathan Hales owes me $20,000.
$20,000? Don't seem like the kind of guy who has $20,000 to lend to anyone.
No, he owes me money. I am going to sue him for $20,000.
How does he owe you $20,000?
For all of the punitive damages that he and his friends on that DS board have caused me over the years, and I want my money. I want him to experience what it's like to be homeless.
What is a DS board? D as in dog, S as in Sam, DS? Is that what you're saying?
No, it's called the Death Squad board, but
Death
I call
Squad.
It something else.
Okay.
Yeah, I call it something.
So you're surprised that
you went on a board called Death Squad and somebody was mean to you? What are you thinking? Go someplace where people are going to be nice to you. Go to the Barney chat room.
All of these people. We all used to hang
he
out.
He loves you.
listen.
Oh,
I'm
yes, we're
right,
with rapt attention
me.
Here. Wait, did he just curse? I don't know. I'm going to drop. I'm going to drop him off the line. I thought he might have said the F-bomb there.
Oh.
I wasn't real sure about that.
Yeah.
Better safe than sorry.
Yeah.
You know, we can't have, a...
And we already know enough about Dave to know that he would just start repeating himself in another 10 seconds anyway, so I'm sure we weren't really missing much of what it was ultimately that was going to come out of his mouth. But let's talk briefly about Dave for a moment, because, Rich, you seem unfamiliar with Dave, and I'm sure we have new listeners in our audience.
I don't remember Dave, but I have talked to some nutbags on the air. I try to forget about him.
He is the first time Dave called the show was probably 2 years ago now, and his calls over the years have varied in somewhat to their substance, but ultimately break down to the same thing, meaning that Dave is upset that someone treated him poorly on the internet.
And or he's upset about someone that is making money off of YouTube.
Show us where the internet touched you.
Yeah. That's apparently now he wants to sue them for $20,000. There are these message boards that he will go on. And thing with Dave is, it's not that he just shows up and people are mean to him. Dave is also mean in the first place. So Dave shows up on these online forums and is very, very rude and obnoxious to people. And then he's surprised and angry when people give him back what it is that he's putting into the world.
Mm.
So
Dave is getting a taste of his own medicine, and he doesn't like it. He can dish it out, but he can't take it. And every time it happens, or not every time, but often enough, he'll call in here to complain about the most recent iteration of whichever board it was, because that's one of the things that has changed over time.
How did you win that honor? I mean, did you put out a counseling card? We're the only show who will take calls, right?
Like, I mean, we're the only show that will take calls from anybody on a nationwide level. That's
okay.
You know, he can call Free Talk Live, but if you were to try calling Rush Limbaugh, he's not going to get on the air, right?
Right.
So that's how we got the honor of Dave Grady calling us from Poughkeepsie, New York, with all manner of various complaints about behavior on the internet.
So never let it be said that low standards don't pay off.
Our toll-free number, if you want to join us here, you can bring up anything, is 855-450-FREE. And we've tried your advice, Rich. We tried to suggest to Dave that he go to someplace where he's not going to get into fights with people, but it's his personality. Yeah. He brings that to the table. He's rude, he's nasty, he's mean. And, you know, then he's shocked that other people will do that to him.
I kind of feel bad about sending him to the Barney chat room. I wonder how that's going to go.
They might tear him up.
I think he should just watch a 10-hour loop of Nyan Cat. I think that would be very therapeutic.
Nyan Cat, that is a meme, correct?
Yes, a Pop-Tart cat.
Yes, that is a video. It's a Pop-Tart cat.
Right. So there you go. There's your latest from Dave Grady. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. That's 855-450-3733. How my first arrest changed my opinions of police. We can still talk about that. And then also, here's the news about the man who's a business entrepreneur, Men's Warehouse founder, George Zimmer. You might remember him from television.
Yeah.
Did a lot of fairly noteworthy commercials over the years for Men's Warehouse, said that he has recreationally smoked weed for half a century. A story from HuffingtonPost.com. Zimmer told CNBC, quote, "I've been smoking marijuana on a regular basis for about 50 years. As you can see, it's really impacted me in a negative way."
He likes the way you look, after all.
Zimmer delivered the keynote speech at the Cannabis World Congress and Business Expo in Los Angeles on Friday. In his speech, he said, quote, "Everybody in the country knows what the truth here is, except the 535 people we elect to make these decisions in Washington, D.C. It's astounding." The apparel executive who was fired from the menswear chain 2 years ago is the fifth major business leader to come out in favor of legalizing marijuana. Whole Foods co-CEO John Mackey, who's also a libertarian, by the way, Virgin Group founder Richard Branson, billionaire financier George Soros, and Peter Lewis, the late progressive insurance chairman who died 2 years ago, all backed such legislation.
Why didn't they include the Koch brothers? They're also big time on that bandwagon. They finance some of the marijuana fight, as I understand.
Well, it is a Huffington Post story.
Oh, that's why.
The 5 decades of getting high doesn't seem to have squashed Zimmer's motivation. He recently launched 2 menswear ventures, a tuxedo rental site called Generation Tux, and a tailoring company called Z Tailor. So he's still in the suits business, even though he's no longer leading Men's Warehouse.
Well, next time I do the 420 rally in a tux, I'm going to send him a letter and ask him to comp me a nice one.
Well, this is something that I've always said that we should have in the marijuana disobedience / legalization movement, is we need men and women with like business attire, people who are upstanding members of the business community who are willing to come out of the closet and admit to being marijuana users to help counteract the misinformation, this sort of drug war propaganda that cannabis users are only shiftless losers.
Well, I used to sell some weed to those people, but they really don't want to come out.
To the business owners, you mean?
Yes.
Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, but that's what it's going to take. We need more people with courage like George Zimmer. Thanks, George, for doing that. It's great stuff. 855-450-FREE. Join us here. This is Free Talk Live.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Are you a sneezer? If you're not, can you get close to one? I don't literally mean someone sneezing. Sneezer, as defined by marketing guru Seth Godin, is an opinion leader. When a sneezer mentions something, other people catch what Godin calls the idea virus. Seth Godin says some people are more likely to tell their friends about a great new idea. So identifying and courting sneezers is a key success factor for idea merchants. His book, Unleashing the Idea Virus, is the most downloaded ebook in history, and you can download the whole book free. That's how he's making his idea contagious. Click tips, tricks, and other stuff to help you cut through the clutter at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $6 lower at $1,147 per ounce. Silver is down 2 cents at $15.18 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $236. The prospect for getting ahead on silver American Eagles looks bad, but we have plenty of spiders, Britannias, and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
You're privileged to drive the road. You must follow the law.
No, I don't have to.
You're going to make a double park, and you're going to make a left-hand turn in front of a cop?
Can I respond to you here, Barbara?
Go right ahead.
I'm not going to run a red light in front of a cop because he has a gun and is willing to hurt me, but I've run plenty
of... Wrong. He's not going to hurt you. He's going to give you a ticket.
Oh, but if I decide not to pull over, what will he do?
Well, that you're not obeying the law.
Barbara, I don't obey arbitrary words written down by strangers. Natural law, Barbara. That means if I do something, I expect consequences will come from that, sometimes
right.
Good,
you
sometimes bad.
You run a red
bad.
Light, somebody comes around, and you kill them. You're not,
I would never run a red light like that. When I run a red light, I stop first, look around, make sure no one is in danger, and then I go through.
You are such a phony.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm. You're listening to the best Liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 in the studio tonight. You've got me, Ian.
Danica.
And Rich Paul.
You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features on the site. And if you care about your privacy when you're online, you need to protect yourself, and ProXPN can help you with that. They are a virtual private network, and they encrypt your online data before it reaches your internet service provider. ProXPN does it right, offering OpenVPN, the gold standard of network encryption. And they've got apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, plus Linux support as well. So setup is super easy. ProXPN, by the way, unlike those other guys, ProXPN, they do not keep logs of your activities whatsoever. And they've got servers now more so than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. They've also integrated Nunkly.com to mask your emails. And if you get, if you get their premium account, which you can do, you can actually do it with credit card and even Bitcoin. Plus, get 50% off their regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy an annual account with code FTL50, which is pretty darn affordable with that code. But here's an even better deal. Now, you can still use the FTL50 code if you feel like it, but if you pay with Bitcoin, you can actually get 2 years' worth of Pro XPN for only $49.95. Plus, $5 of your purchase will go to the AMP program when you go to this URL to get started, proxpn.com/AMP. So this actually helps Free Talk Live directly with the AMP program getting $5 out of your $49.95. And you're getting a huge savings on Pro XPN. You do the math, 2 years' worth of Pro XPN for $50, basically. That's cheap. Per month, I think that breaks down to less than, between $2 or $3 per month. It's incredible. So, but you can only get the huge savings if you pay with Bitcoin.
That's
so,
cheaper than a Pandora subscription.
It's incredible. ProXPN.com/AMP. Take advantage of that new AMP offer. Or, of course, you can still use code FTL50. ProXPN.com/AMP. All right, let's go to the phones and the fun. Let's talk to Calvin listening in St. Louis. You're on Free Talk Live, the Ian, Danica, and Rich Paul. Calvin.
Hey, Ian. Glad to join you guys tonight. I wanted to discuss the issue of this challenge, because you guys had that caller earlier who got a speeding ticket, and their instrumentation to calculate speed was dubious at best. But there was a moment in the discussion where you guys were discussing challenging jurisdiction, whether that's effective or not. And just for a short plug, we have another radio host that broadcasts tomorrow, Mark Stevens. I work with him, so for full disclosure. But on the question of whether or not challenging jurisdiction works, I'll go on the record and saying, and you don't have to take my word or anyone else's word for this, but it has worked in the past, and you can find examples and documentation on Mark's website at markstevens.net/successes. To add in, I recently had a case personally here in St. Louis where I didn't get the – now, when we talk about whether something works or not, there's different definitions people will use. Some people, hire lawyers, and what works for them is getting it amended. So, and then for other people, what quote-unquote works is getting it dismissed. And we've had both outcomes. In my case, I challenged jurisdiction, and the prosecutor here is very hard-headed, and I've had – a very hard time getting success here, but I was able to hammer out a plea bargain deal where at least I was able to get points on my license, and it was pretty easy. In fact, the prosecutor approached me with a plea bargain. I was just wanting to challenge jurisdiction, and jurisdiction isn't necessarily am I located here. There are also other jurisdictional elements, whether there's actual loss, injury, harm, the violation of someone's legal right, damage, those types of things. So those are also jurisdictional challenges. So I just wanted to put that out there to the listeners that challenging jurisdiction can work. Your mileage will vary greatly depending on where you're at and how far the state has dug their heels in your community. But it has worked. There's examples of it. It really comes down to whether or not someone's willing to commit themselves to actually learning the language in a courtroom and being able to overcome the intimidation from both the prosecutor and the judge, because as we all know here on Free Talk Live in your audience, those two actors are one of the same team.
Well, that's definitely true. Well, what we do up in Keene is we record all of our court appearances. And that's something I would really like to see from the challenge, jurisdiction challenging and sovereign citizen communities. And there's several communities that have novel approaches to courtrooms. Mm-hmm. And I would love to have somebody come up here, do some civil disobedience, maybe go out and smoke a joint on the square, although that might not get you arrested anymore. But
you could
just
park your car wrong and then get a parking ticket.
There you go.
Yeah, and do it and let us film you.
Some weed in public around there. Sign me up.
Well, we had a rally, and we went out every day at 4:20 in the afternoon for about 2 years and smoked weed on the square. They arrested me 3 times and arrested a couple other people. And they realized we weren't going to go away, so they just kind of left us alone. And so,
I remember that. I'm a big fan of that activism.
Yeah, yeah,
that's what you brought up, Rich. I asked Ian. We actually do have some instances between Ian and Derek J. They have brought up this line of questioning and challenging jurisdiction in court. In Ian's case, it's actually on the Free Keen YouTube channel. Mark was able to appear in court via video and challenge jurisdiction. It was allowed to go on for about an hour. The prosecutor never won.
That actually wasn't court. It was a DMV hearing. It was an administrative hearing, so it wasn't court at all. But it was a very entertaining video with Mark Stevens from Adventures in Legal Land going at it with this DMV administrator. That DMV administrator was not happy about what he was being subjected to and ultimately ended up cutting Mark off. And Derek did try some of the Mark Stevens questions here, but Judge Burks, you know, he's no newbie to this stuff, so he shut it down fairly quickly. But, you know, Rich, I agree with you that I would love to see some of these folks with the legal theories put their theories into effect on video. I mean, because all the time we hear them calling in to Mark's show, if you listen on to LRN.FM on Saturday afternoon, he gets people calling in telling their stories. But you never hear them, you know, say that they recorded their case. And usually when I ask them, when I ask anybody about their case, wherever it is they are, they say that you just can't record in other courts in elsewhere, you know, outside of New Hampshire. It's just not something that's very easy to do or even an option that's on the table. Do you know, Calvin, if in Missouri you can record in a courtroom?
Oh, it's extremely difficult. I've tried many times myself, and the rules will tell you that you can. All you have to do is seek permission, as long as it's not basically disruptive. Mm-hmm. They should be, you know, according to the rules, they should allow you. However, in practice, they will never let you record, especially if you're actually going in pro se per and, you know, being a cog in their clogging up their system and actually challenging their authority. If that's the case, it's almost guaranteed that you will not get a camera in a Missouri courtroom. So again, that's what's so attractive about New Hampshire. Mark's mentioned that several times. If more free staters were able to go in there with the questions and really bring it up in a very coherent manner and persistently, you know, because you see Mark himself go at it for about an hour, and that really didn't yield great results. So, you know, we're a big fan of the court videos that are produced from the Free Keen channel, but that is a hard thing depending on, well, for most states, is getting that video footage in there. However, I do agree that it's very powerful to have that out there so that people are able to emulate that and be able to use that to their own advantage to really correct some of the damage that government does whenever they take our resources, whenever they take our money and, you know, our labor away from us. So,
yeah, you know, we're real good at clogging the system up here. And in fact, I was actually in court this week. Our friend Derek J. Freeman has moved to San Francisco for a period of time, and he had a parking ticket case that he was going to take to court on Wednesday of this week. And I reminded him about it on Monday, and he had forgotten all about it. And so I told him, well, look, I'll try to go in there and, you know, act as the administrator for the case because it was actually a corporate car that was ticketed. So because it's a corporate car, that means anybody who's authorized should be able to take the case. Thanks, Calvin, for your call tonight. I'll tell you what happened here in moments. I did get it on video, but I've been so busy with other things, I haven't put it up on YouTube. It's Free Talk Live.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only. The makers of O2Pure, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. Valued at $99, these starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-717-9859. The revolutionary O2Pure design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no nasty tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love whenever and wherever they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with O2Pure. Again, free starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859.
Wait a minute. Don't spend a dime on emergency food storage until you visit ReadySupplyFoods.com. If you're interested in getting the most high-quality food for your money, then see our comparison page where we list all the companies and rank them by value for your dollar. you'll see that Ready Supply Foods sells 50% more food for your money than any other company. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. Make an informed decision by going to ReadySupplyFood.com today.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, Georgia, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait,
you want to come. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared of me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We've got Free Talk Live. You can join us here if you like. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online at freetalklive.com. We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show here and bring up anything. Skype username is lrn.fm. Now, if you get online at all and you like to order, let's say, products on Amazon, you want to save big time on your next order and every order after that, go to saveatpurse.com and get started with an account at saveatpurse.com, where you can then start ordering things through Amazon with Bitcoin and save 20% on average if you're in the United States. Other countries, there's different averages, but 20% is your average discount, which means that you can get a higher than 20% discount. I've done it, 29% on the headphones I'm wearing, 40% on the most recent Blu-ray that I ordered. If you want to save big time on your already great deal Amazon purchases, then you owe it to yourself to check out saveatpurse.com. Even if you don't have Bitcoin yet, go ahead and get an account started at saveatpurse.com. This is like reason number one to get some Bitcoin. Like, if this is a good pitch to folks, hey, you need a reason to get Bitcoin? How about 20% off Amazon? Saveatpurse.com. Our toll-free number again, 855-450-FREE. We were talking about court and challenging tickets and things like that, and it's just unfortunate that a lot of these folks who have great ideas, in the courtroom aren't able to actually document effectively them putting their ideas into use. And that's what you had suggested, Rich, was that people should record video of themselves challenging jurisdiction or whatever other kind of court tactic it is that they want to try out. Because we know one thing's for sure, that, you know, in all the different times we've tried different things here in the Keene area, nothing works consistently. So it's very hard to find any kind of courtroom theory that is actually going to be reliable. But even if there was something reliable, we would never really know if, from all the people who are out there outside of New Hampshire claiming to be putting these tactics into effect, because you just have to take their word for it. You know, nobody's going to go and buy the transcript from the Joe Blowtown District Court to verify this person's claim as to whether or not their tactic actually worked in court. If it's not on video, it might as well have not have happened.
Yeah, and I would say on exactly the same theory, and we are in a pictures or it didn't happen society where, you know, If you can't show somebody some video that they don't want to hear about it. A lot of people don't read newspapers. You know, they don't read very much at all. And I would say it violates the constitutional right to a fair and speedy trial, or a speedy and public trial. I'm sorry. To then say you can't have cameras in there. In what sense is it then public? I can't see what happened there. I'm
exactly
a long way away, and people have a right to know what their government is up to. So I would like, I don't know, I wonder how many people have challenged this on constitutional grounds and whether there's room for something similar to the Glick decision to, you know, one thing to do would be to actually try recording in a courtroom and get arrested and fight them. And I think your results would be best in federal court.
Yeah, I think you'd be right about that. But of course, you know, now we're asking the average person who on their own is likely not going to take something to court. So of the people who are willing to take something to court, you're asking them to go ahead and put themselves on the line with a possible arrest. Now you're whittling down even further the window of possible, or the amount of possible people who would be willing to go through with this. Further, the person who'd be willing to face arrest would then also have to have either the connections in the legal world to get a good attorney, because you're not going to go to federal court without somebody who knows what the hell they're doing, right? You're not just going to bumble your way through to success on that one.
Pro se prisoners do it all the time.
Do they win?
A lot of their... Sometimes they do.
Yeah, but that's because all they have time to do is research, right? Like, they're in prison.
That's true.
The average person, they're busy. They're trying to pay the bills.
They are. But, you know, then again, 7 years ago, I was the average person who wouldn't have had time or energy to take a ticket to court. I mean, The last arrest I had before I moved to New Hampshire, I got arrested in Ohio for driving on suspended license on my way from Michigan back to Florida. And I just called up an Ohio attorney and said, I'll send you however much money you need, make it so I don't have to go back there and go to court, because I've got work to do.
And that's why people don't generally go to court. They've got work, they've got family, they've got responsibilities, they've got things that keep them busy, and the court is the least interesting thing to the average person.
Yeah. You know? But people change. I've gone to court a few times since then.
Oh, yeah. No doubt. I mean, I'm not saying it's impossible, but, you know, to find someone who's willing to go to court, who's willing to challenge a ticket, willing to further be arrested for recording in court... I mean, we can't find those people, and we're in the activist movement, right?
Well, I was actually thinking, if you're willing to do all those things, why don't you just move to New Hampshire? And we'd love to have you.
Really, I think that's the best option here. I mean, because we do have a support system here. We do have activists who will come and back you up in a courtroom, and, you know, I'll be there with my video camera, likely. If you're in Keene for trial, I'll probably be there if you are a liberty-oriented person. And in this case, I was in court this week. Derek J. Freeman had a parking ticket trial. Now, this was going to be a different trial. I've been to a bunch of parking ticket trials, not just for me, but for other people there to observe others who have challenged their parking tickets. And we're talking about a $5 parking ticket. So this is not a big risk. You know, you're not putting anything significant on the line. Now,
With that said, anytime you're in a courthouse, you're out there, you're subject to the whims of the bureaucrats in the courthouse. If they get a hair up their butt and they decide they don't like you and they want to trump you up on some kind of nonsense charges, they certainly can. So anytime,
have a seat.
Yeah, exactly. Anytime you're in the courthouse, anything can happen. But generally, going in on a speeding ticket for $5 is a fairly low risk activity when it comes to court. Yeah. So that's what
and
I was.
If you do lose, you can just pay it in pennies, like some of us do.
You can't. I don't know. Has anyone ever done a parking ticket with pennies before?
Or what? Oh, no, wait. It was a news story that someone paid a ticket in pennies, but didn't.
I don't know if it was here.
Did Garrett pay in quarters or nickels? Didn't he?
I don't recall.
I think he paid in Obama coin. Yeah, the quarters with the little Obama pictures.
That's funny still.
So, anyway, Derek J. got this ticket, but he wasn't driving his car at the time. He was driving a corporate car, a car owned by a corporation. So I've never gone to a trial where the corporation was the person who was ticketed, right? Because in the crazy world of the legal land, corporations are persons. And so what happened?
Well, okay, let me just stop and give a brief clarification on that. Personhood under the law means anything that can own property, enter into a contract, or be sued. So corporations are... To say that corporations are legal people is not unreasonable, and that way predates Citizens United.
Oh, no, I understand that, but it's still pretty ridiculous, in my opinion, to call a corporation a person. They're not a person. It's just that's a legal term, and it's been redefined how they want to define it. They can define things how they want.
Maybe they should use a different word, but there would have to be a word that that has exactly those characteristics. It can own property, it can be sued, and it can enter into contracts, or businesses could not enter into contracts. Managers of stores would have to enter into personal contracts with their suppliers because they couldn't be sued. They're not people.
Yeah, I just think it's a weird thing, right? Like to say that a corporation is a person. I understand that's how the system works, and that's just sort of part and parcel of
things are. It would be nice if they'd used the word legal entity
legal fiction,
or something.
Legal entity, yeah.
Well, legal fiction, of course, is any legal person which is not a human is a legal fiction.
Which is what a corporation
is.
Yeah,
or a government. A government is just a corporation that claims extraordinary powers.
That's correct. So in this case, it was a corporate-owned car, and Derek had gone into the parking department because when you get a parking ticket, if you want a trial, you have to go to the department and tell them that you want a trial, and then they schedule the trial for you. So he went in there, and he took sort of responsibility for the ticket, meaning that he was going to be the agent for the corporation who was handling the trial for the corporation, as I understood it. But when I went into court, and I was expecting to be able to go in there and just say, hey, look, I've got this permission from Derek J. He's written this out saying I can be the agent instead of him in this particular case. They acted like they didn't know this was a corporate case. They acted like this was Derek's case. So apparently when he went in there originally to challenge the ticket, they just went ahead and just put everything under his name, and so there was no evidence for the judge to look at that showed the judge that this was a corporate car. And the judge said that you might have been able to do this had Derek actually filed a motion in advance, because it was that day. It was the morning of. So it was just too late to get in there. I tried. The
thing is, that ticket didn't have a name on it. It just had a license plate number. That's how parking tickets are.
Right, but
so
when he
like
went in to challenge it, they put his name on the case file.
Oh, so they're saying he accepted responsibility, and so now you can't shift it back.
855, 450, free. Well, they said I might have been able to shift it had he put the motion in.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it.
Get started with Bitcoin at Bitcoin.com. It's Bitcoin.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, September 25th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.08 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,144 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports over the weekend, local officials reported that Syria's government and al-Qaeda had reached yet another ceasefire in the city of Zabadani and the Idlib villages of Fua and Kafraya. Unlike previous weekend ceasefires, this was to be an open-ended deal. The ceasefire appears to have led to further delay on Thursday, with the two sides agreeing to mutual evacuation from the area. Under the agreement, al-Qaeda will be allowed to withdraw its fighters from Zabadani and Idlib, and they'll let some 10,000 civilians from Fua and Kafraya flee from Idlib into governmental territory. Fua and Kafraya are Shiite villages and were left surrounded by al-Qaeda after recent military losses in the province. Zabadani is surrounded by Hezbollah fighters who are trying to drive al-Qaeda out of the area along the Lebanese border. Interestingly, while the agreement effectively turns Zabadani over to the Hezbollah-led forces, it does not allow pro-Syrian militias to withdraw from Fua and Kafraya, meaning the villages will remain under government control, albeit without any civilian population. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports Republicans in the U.S. House of Representatives will hear a proposal Friday that would strip federal funding for Planned Parenthood, but avoid the government shutdown that looms over the issue, according to sources. House Speaker John Boehner is pitching the strategy, which would fast-track the move against the organization and put it on President Obama's desk without having to risk a shutdown. The strategy will be discussed Friday in a closed-door meeting. Boehner's motive with this strategy is to satisfy the 30 GOP House members who are willing to risk a shutdown if the stripping of Planned Parenthood is not attached to a critical spending bill. However, Bloomberg Politics reported Thursday some in the House may consider challenging Boehner's leadership. The current spending arrangement expires September 30th. The Senate is planning to submit a new spending bill which would fund the government through December 11th. However, analysts say Boehner's plan might not work because Obama would likely veto the bill stripping Planned Parenthood and Republicans don't have enough votes in the Senate for an override.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a U.S. Border Patrol agent has been indicted for murder in a cross-border shooting of a Mexican teenager in 2012 in what an attorney for the victim's family on Thursday called an unprecedented move. A federal grand jury on Wednesday indicted agent Lonnie Schwartz for second-degree murder in the October 10, 2012 shooting death of 16-year-old Jose Antonio Elana Rodriguez. Elana Rodriguez was shot through a fence separating the cities of Nogales, Arizona, where Schwartz was on patrol, and Nogales, Mexico, where the teen was walking. Officials have said Ilana Rodriguez was throwing rocks over the border fence at the agents. He was shot multiple times in the back, according to Louis Parra, an Arizona attorney who is representing the family in a civil suit filed last year. Parra said to his knowledge it was unprecedented for a Border Patrol agent to be charged with murder in a cross-border shooting. He said Schwartz has since been suspended without pay and ordered to turn in his weapon and his badge. Attorney Sean Chapman, who is representing Schwartz, was unavailable for comment on Thursday. Representatives for U.S. Customs and Border Protection could not be immediately reached. A union representing Border Patrol agents across the western United States spoke out against the charges on Thursday in a post on the union website. The union asked that the public withhold judgment while the criminal case plays out and said Schwartz is innocent. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Odds are, if you've looked outside recently, you've noticed that all dogs everywhere are running. Scientists can't explain why all over the world, dogs of every breed are running nonstop. I'm joined now by animal behavior expert, Dr. Charles Davenport. Charles, what can you tell us?
All we know for sure is that the dogs are running fast.
But we don't know why the dogs are running?
There are a few reasons that dogs normally run. Because they're excited or scared, or they see something they want far away, or because they're happy. However, usually, they don't run at the same time or in the same direction.
Do we have any idea where the dogs are running?
West. All the dogs are running west.
Do we expect the dogs to ever stop running?
We don't know. Animal behavior can evolve over time. Maybe running forever is just what the dogs do now.
Dr. Davenport, is there any chance that the running dogs are somehow related to last night's blue meteor shower? Or the fact that horses are screaming?
Inconclusive.
Well, please keep us posted. Up next, where are all the children?
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us on the radio waves here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. And whether it's courtroom tactics or bad cops, those are some of the things we've discussed here. You can join us on whatever happens to be on your mind with you tonight. In studio, you've got me, Ian.
Danica.
Friar Rich.
And our toll-free number again, 855-450-FREE. Don't forget, we've got Skype at Skype, username lrn.fm. Story from from truthvoice.com. Jordan Freshour is the writer. Saturday, September 19th, 2015, I was arrested for photographing the police in Cincinnati, Ohio. This was my first arrest, and I want to talk about it, says Jordan. He says, I've gradually become involved with the police accountability movement over the last year. I've had the good fortune of meeting the most influential and hardworking gonzo journalists and activists in the Midwest, and with them I found a safe place to fight for the rights of my friends and neighbors here in Southwest Ohio, my home. It's my friendships with these people which allowed for the viral outbreak of support after being locked in a cage. That being said, I was immersed in a new experience regarding the police state in America. Foremost, the risk of losing your own freedom because of principles is real. I was doing nothing more than photographing the arrest of Talis Gage when my hands were grabbed and tightly zip-tied behind my back. I tossed my camera to the curb and went peacefully. For there is no reasoning with psychopaths. The video of my arrest was shot by Benjamin Vernston, who was also arrested, for documenting the event. After being kidnapped for 7+ hours, I was released due to the goodwill of Micah Ben David posting bond. I was searched 3 times, fingerprinted 2x, my belongings were taken, and I was given an armband. All normal procedure, but a dehumanizing one, which treats citizens like cattle. Once processed, an officer herded me to the top floor of the Reading Road Correction Center and into an isolated cell, completely alone and without explanation, for the next 3 hours.
Frankly, it was anxiety-inducing, not knowing if my bail was posted or when I would be released. I did push-ups and read the names of past prisoners scratched into the drab, semi-gloss, painted cinder-block walls to pass the time. Sounds kind of familiar, Rich Paul.
Oh, yeah. I got to where I could do 600 push-ups a day.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Many have had a night in jail, and sadly, many have experienced the far worse treatment from the police. A fortunate man I would be to escape the brunt of police violence for the rest of my life. Thousands are not able to say that. There's no comparison between me and them, and I don't think my story to be more important than another's. However, such a thing does not make the behavior of Cincinnati's lamest any less commendable. I'm a highly social person, as many are, writes Jordan. In those few hours of isolation, I understood the purpose of incarceration in a new way. Being in jail is not a punishment. Banishment from the world is. I realized that jail is not a place where bad people go to be rehabilitated or to serve their time, but rather a coward's device used to silence opposition. Any individual who thinks it's acceptable to isolate another person from all outside interaction, even for a short while, is not a human, him or herself, and should not be given the dignity of being recognized as such. Well, I think that's a little harsh. I think that they're humans, but they're seriously misled, and they're doing a very inhumane thing to their fellow man.
And I wouldn't say necessarily psychopath, because when you say psychopath, it medicalizes it. It makes it something beyond their control. A psychopath can't help but be a psychopath. He's
That's
sick.
True. They're born
a
that way.
A cop has been indoctrinated and taught a set of mythology with which justifies his actions. It's the state as religion that allows this to be done. Just like people have done a lot of horrible things in the name of any of other religions, because any time you let something become more important in your mind than human life, then you're liable to be willing to kill and hurt people to advance that goal. And that's why I accept no higher standard than human life.
Yeah, I think you make a good point there, Rich, about psychopaths. These jail guards, for the most part, at least in my experience here in Cheshire County, are not psychopaths. Cheshire County's jail in New Hampshire is probably a lot better than the average jail anywhere else in the country, where they definitely do hire some psychopaths at a number of jails and sociopaths as well. But these guards, we know a couple of guards who've quit the jail. There's Brian Tan, who...
Absolutely not a psychopath.
Right.
I love Brian.
He spoke at the first convention.
And I was his prisoner at one time. I was on his block. But the other thing is, you have to be careful in collectivizing people, because I believe that some of the people who were working in that jail said, wow, this is really awful for these guys, and most of them don't deserve it, and I'm working here, but I'm going to make it as easy and pleasant for these guys, and I'm going to be nice, you know, except when I have to do it in order to avoid violence. And then there are other people who go in there, and these are, to me, the sadists and the psychopaths are the ones who go in there and they say, I'm going to make this harder for these guys.
They get pleasure from that.
Exactly. Yeah. If they get pleasure from it, then it's sadism. And if it's just being completely shocked that anybody could stand up against the state, then it's probably an overdose of the religion of statism.
Yeah, it's absolutely the case. And you and I have both been in the same facility, the Cheshire County Jail, which some of us like to call the Keene Spiritual Retreat. And, you know, credit to Rick Van Wickler, who's the jail warden. He's actually a member of law enforcement against prohibition. And I think that's an indicator that you're dealing with a guy running a jail who's a cut above your average jail warden. You know, he still has his issues. He still has some things on which, you know, we disagree. But ultimately, I believe that the policies that he brings to the plate in that jail are a reason why there are better people working there. I think he makes a deliberate effort to try to hire a better kind of jail guard than the average jail does. I believe that's the case.
I think he probably makes that effort, yes.
So I think that, you know, having that level of
I'm not going to say it's a caring jail, but having that level of more humanity, I guess, mm-hmm. in an institution that is generally very inhumane is a nice mm-hmm. thing to have. And it's a good reason to also consider moving to New Hampshire and specifically the Cheshire County area. If you're, especially if you're going to do civil disobedience, you know, if your plan is to do civil disobedience, it's a good idea to do civil disobedience in a place where, you know, they'll actually serve you real eggs in jail. And, you know, you get a fairly decent jail meal when you're in the mm-hmm. Cheshire County Jail, as opposed to, let's say, Joe Arpaio's jail in the middle of the desert in Arizona, where they feed you rotting bologna, you know, once a day.
True. And I got to say, let me shout out to Butch, the jail cook, because that guy rocked.
Yeah,
I really liked him. He was one of the people I enjoyed talking to there.
Sorry, Danica, what were you saying?
Oh, doesn't Joe Arpaio's prisoners have to stay out in the sun, too?
Some of them do. There's Tent City, where, mm-hmm. yes, they are in the hot desert literally all day long and all night.
Well, yeah. I'll tell you, Superintendent Van Wickler had a conversation with me about that guy.
Really?
And he doesn't like him. And he said the thing is that in the area that he's in, there's some relatively tough prisoners, but the people who go to these camps with the pink underwear and the tents, the gimmick camps, he says, those aren't those people. He said if you tried to do that with people who hadn't agreed to go to those camps for a shorter sentence, mm-hmm. that basically, he said there would be riots. So what he's doing is he's making a showcase where he's giving shorter sentences to inmates in exchange for them putting on a dog and pony show.
So he
for
can
him,
show how
my
tough
impression.
Of a sheriff he is.
Exactly, it's a PR gig.
That's all it is.
So I don't know whether the bologna is rotting. No, I do know they make. But you know, if somebody had said you can go
died.
To.
There are people who've died from, not from the bologna, but from the lack of water because they're in the desert and it's hot. And as you imagine.
Heat prostration is a real problem. Yeah. You got to hydrate your hippies.
Toll free number, but you can't hydrate yourself if the water fountain doesn't work, right? Like, so if there's issues like that.
That's inexcusable.
Toll free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. But I understand where Jordan is coming from here. The guy who's been arrested, he's angry. He's upset at the whole process.
Oh, absolutely. I don't mean to belittle anything that he said.
Free Talk Live.
Has this ever happened to you? You're applying for some type of a loan, whether online or in person. When it's time to hit submit, your nerves spike because you're not sure you'll get the approval you seek. There's a different way to approach life. It's called Credit Success Secrets Revealed. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is a revolutionized step-by-step system that you can follow to get all the credit you desire today. We're talking about secured and unsecured credit, car leases, credit cards, and cash. Call 800-568-8960. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works no matter what your current situation, whether you've had bad credit, never had credit, or looking for some business credit, or any type of credit. Please call 800-568-8960. We don't take any personal information. Your personal information is way too valuable to trust to a third-party email or a website that doesn't answer the phone. At Credit Success Secrets Revealed, we show you step-by-step what to place into the financial computer systems that control your credibility in the marketplace today. We practically fill out the forms for you. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works 100% of the time. Call now, 800-568-8960. That's 800-568-8960. 800-568-8960.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation.
Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
You can join us here on Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What's it like to get arrested the first time? It was a shock for Jordan Freshour over at truthvoice.com. We're sharing his story about what it was like and commenting, because Rich, you and I have both been through this process a number of times. Danica, have you ever been arrested?
No.
Okay, all right. Well, give him time. So also, I want you to know about freedomsphoenix.com. They're uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies every day over at freedomsphoenix.com, where you're provided the detailed real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. freedomsphoenix.com has up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to freedomsphoenix.com. Get signed up for their free daily dispatch. That's freedomsphoenix.com. Let's go to the phones, and I want to talk more about Jordan's experience in jail, his first time. He was there for 7 hours being held until he was bonded out, and it was a difficult experience for him, as it is for most people. And we'll talk about why that is and more here in a moment. But first, Joe is on the line listening in New Jersey to LRN.FM. Hello, Joe.
And I did not swear at all. You didn't give me a chance to finish to what I was saying. Okay, can I finish?
All right. Generally, it's only one call per night, but I'll give you this one. Go ahead, Dave.
Yeah, because I never swear on Free Talk Live.
All right, so you're going to complain because you want to sue some people on the internet. You want $20,000 because they called you some mean names on a message forum.
Yeah, the board's name is called the Death Squad, and you know I'm gonna the guy lives in Pennsylvania, Philadelphia somewhere. His name is Jonathan Hales, and I'm gonna sue him for all of the punitive damages that he has caused me.
How have you lost $20,000 worth of value because you went on a message forum and got in arguments with people?
All of this started way back on howardshrine.net, and then it moved to the Yuku boards, and then he started his own message board where everyone goes on there and they can't even take it down. And this guy, Big Daddy, used to stand up for me. He is now, he died of some causes or whatever way back when. But, you know, Jonathan Hales has all these friends, Tickleweed, Mook H, IAC.
We don't need to know who they are. It really doesn't matter.
Yeah. And, you know, I'm just sick of it.
You didn't answer the question, though. Okay, you didn't answer the question. So
what did these people say to you? I want to find a $20,000 insult. I've got somebody to use it on.
Like, seriously, what did they do that caused $20,000 worth of damages?
Yeah, where'd you come up with that number?
I just came up with a random number. And
okay, at least you admitted you just pulled that number out of your butt. Okay.
What was the question? Let me answer your question. What was the question?
What on God's green earth did they say to you?
They just keep on calling me names like cat killer. I am not a cat killer. And
did they call you a leech?
I am not a leech. I look to work every day. I am not a leech at all. I look for work every day. You know.
But in the meantime, you're taking welfare, right?
I'm going to sue Jonathan Hales for $20,000.
You are on welfare, though, right? Like, because you're not working.
Well, not if he gets that money out of Jonathan Hales.
Who pays your rent?
Didn't you say that you work at Dunkin' Donuts or something? A Dunkin' Donuts?
The what?
You probably don't. You lost your job, right?
Back in 2013 when I was working for Hertz, but, you know, Jonathan Hales and all of his friends, I'm going to sue them.
Who pays your rent?
Jonathan Hales.
Who pays your rent? Who pays your rent? You do. So you've got savings?
Yes.
Uh-huh. So you saved a bunch of money back in 2013. How much do you have in savings?
That really doesn't matter. But, like, you know, I'm going to sue him because him and all of his friends. He's going to give me his house, his cars, his bank assets, everything.
Okay, well, we've been talking about this tonight. So could you videotape this case? Because I would really like to see what it looks and sounds like when you tell this story to a judge. You're going pro se, I assume.
The what?
Are you going pro se? Are you representing yourself?
Yes, I'm going to represent myself.
Yes, I want this tape.
Oh, it would be entertaining.
Make me the videotape. You won't win, but send me the tape. It'll be hilarious.
It will be. It'll get kicked out of court probably before it even gets to a hearing, though. I mean, somebody's going to motion to dismiss based on no standing.
I'm going to collect.
Okay. Well, you just let us know how that goes, Dave.
And pictures or it didn't happen. I want to see the video of this.
You know, Dave's actually pretty good with video. I got to give him credit. He's got a YouTube channel. I think he's got like three YouTube channels.
Hudson Valley Guy, that's it.
Hudson Valley Guy, the number one. Hudson Valley
Guy.
Oh,
it's only one? I thought it was five for some reason.
Well, he's got other ones, and I don't know what the other ones are. But the one that I've been to is Hudson Valley Guy 1. Anyway, he's really good. You actually could probably learn a thing or two from him, Rich. He does a lot of video blogging where he'll have the camera sort of pointed at himself and then talk into the camera. Of course, you shouldn't follow anything else that he does because he repeats himself constantly when he's on camera. He'll have a seven-minute-long video.
About saying it to his face.
The first 45 seconds is original content, and then the remaining 6 minutes is just him repeating himself over and over again. So don't take too many tips from him, but he's actually a prolific video producer. He's got a camera. If he wanted to, he could certainly try to get, you know, jump through the hoops and bring that camera into a courtroom. He could certainly try that.
Yeah, I'd like to see that happen. I mean, put in a motion, claim that it violates his right to a public trial, and then you could even do an interlocutory appeal and go to the Supreme Court on that issue, which is way more interesting than the case itself, which is just somebody being butthurt because somebody said something mean on the internet.
And it does sound like he's relatively flush with cash. Since he claims he's not on welfare to pay his rent and that he's paying out of savings, he can certainly afford the filing fee that it's going to cost him to bring this case to bear on his supposed attacker. The you know, this guy on the internet that he doesn't like, who's said things that he doesn't like. Dave, just to, you know, for a little bit of information that you might want to know, it is relatively free speech on the internet. I understand there are rules in some places against what's called cyberbullying. So maybe under a cyberbullying law, you might have a case, because these cyberbullying laws are basically contrary to freedom of speech. And so perhaps that could maybe back you. I don't know. But yeah, I agree with Rich. I would like to see whatever kind of footage is possible to see from this.
Yeah. And as a preacher, let me take a moment to talk about right and wrong. Using the state against somebody is violence, and you do not have the right to do violence against somebody because you don't know what because you don't like what they say. If you don't like what people say, find a way to turn them off. Either get away from them or just don't. I'm sorry, don't go around him.
He keeps creating it, though, for himself. That's the problem. Yeah. Is even if he goes to a new forum, he'll just create new forum enemies there because he's rude and mean to people.
Well, maybe you should get a rock garden instead of going to forums. I mean, rock gardens can be very relaxing. Yeah.
Or just think of the Taylor Swift lyrics. Haters gonna hate. I mean, they're just gonna keep on hating, so it's move true. On.
Well, if you want some spiritual counseling, I do that stuff real cheap.
I didn't know. It wasn't Taylor Swift who came up with that, was it?
Well, no, but she uses it in her songs. Okay. Haters gonna hate, 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 hate.
Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Maybe you've got some tips for Dave and how to avoid conflict on the internet. It's Free Talk Live.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's EATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here on the radio waves. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we've got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. When you Skype in, you generally will sound a lot better than if you call on the phone. So it's worth the effort. If you don't yet have Skype on your smartphone, go ahead and install it and then connect with us at username lrn.fm. The us tonight includes me, Ian.
Danica.
And Rich Paul.
The three of us, by the way, who will be some of the attendees at the upcoming Keenvention, the third annual Keenvention. It's happening in just about a month from now. It's October 30th through November 1st. It's going to be here before you know it. And there's still plenty of tickets available. It's a small event. It's very intimate, meaning that probably won't be that many more than 100 people in total that attend throughout the entire weekend, which means that if you're one of those 100, you get to meet pretty much everybody you want to meet. You want to meet Rich Paul? You can meet Rich Paul. It's not like there's going to be a swarm of hundreds of people there blocking you from him. So
I'll probably smoke you out.
There's a good chance of that. I've heard rumors there might be a 420 on Sunday at the end of the event. In fact, the event is scheduled to end at 4:20 on Sunday, so who knows when that will happen. It could happen Saturday and Friday as well.
I would be surprised if it didn't.
If you're in the right place at the right time. So keenvention.info, that's where you can go to learn more about this event. It is an activist-focused conference. So there's a lot of libertarian conventions out there, and they always bring in these big-name liberty speakers from all around the world and pay thousands of dollars and put them up in hotels, and that brings the price of the ticket up fairly high to these conventions. We don't do that at Keenvention. At Keenvention, it's all New Hampshire-based activists, with the exception of Gavin Andreessen and one guy from Vermont, so our neighbors are also going to be taking part to a very small extent. But for the most part, it's super focused on New Hampshire liberty activists.
Did you say Mark Andreessen?
No, Gavin Andreessen.
Oh, okay.
He's the head programmer for Bitcoin, and he's going to be in attendance at Keenvention. We'll be speaking on the Bitcoin panel. Rich, you're going to be speaking on which panel? I'm spacing on which one.
I'm
secession panel? I don't
know. Jury nullification.
That's it. Jury nullification. Thank you for that.
I couldn't remember either.
I'm organizing the event, and it's just hard to keep it all straight. There's 11 different panels. There are 3 keynote speakers, and it's going to be a good time. Plus,
who are the keynote speakers now?
So Chris Reitman, he's an oath keeper and a town selectman. So he's a Free State Project early mover who's actually made it into the town selectman position here in New Hampshire. So he's going to have some interesting things to say, I think.
Chris rocks.
And then there's also another Chris, Christopher David, the Uber driver, the illegal Uber driver. He is he's going to be our new keynote speaker to replace Chris Cantwell, who withdrew from the event last week. So that's
is
the big announcement.
Is this a Chris thing? Is the theme this year Chris's?
It seems like they're Chris's.
Not purposefully, but I mean, it seemed like he was the obvious choice, right?
Well,
like,
yeah, he's the guy.
He's a mover and a shaker. He appeared on the scene within the last few weeks.
A shaker. That's unusual.
Though you're right. They have kind of shaken themselves out of existence, the shakers did.
It was shaky to begin.
Christopher David, we've talked about him, and I hope we get a chance to give you an update on his case. He is doing civil disobedience as an Uber driver on the seacoast, so he'll be coming out to Keenvention to give a keynote speech on Saturday night. And our very own Daryl W. Perry from fpp.cc will be speaking. He was the 2014 Keen Activist of the Year and well-deserved, a nonstop liberty guy who just does it. He eats, breathes, and sleeps liberty activism constantly. So he definitely earned the keynote position this year at Keenvention. So that's a little highlight from what's going to happen. You want a full list of all the panels and discussions we're going to have, go to keenvention.info. We're still actually announcing full panels as well. So we've announced all of the panel types and what their topics are and their hosts, but not all the panels have been filled out publicly with all of the different attendees. So go and register your tickets. They're $60 for the entire weekend, or you can pay with Bitcoin. So really, it's an unbeatable deal. That price also gets you into the Hallowkeen costume dance party. We also just announced there's going to be a bonfire on Friday night like there was last year.
Oh, that was a great event.
It was really
great. I
love
the bonfire.
Yeah, Conan's bringing the bonfire back, and I'm excited about that. So there's a lot of cool social events that you can go to during Keenvention. You can do some activism, like cop block and Robin Hooding. It's a lot of fun. Go to keenvention.info as we go to Brett, calling from Dallas, Texas on Skype. Hello, Brett.
How you guys doing? About a year ago, I found all the free Keen videos and the activism going on there. Decided to start my own YouTube channel. And over the last year, I've done a lot of First Amendment-type filming of cops and bureaucrats and did a lot of cop blocking and stuff. And eventually had an incident escalate where I was, tackled to the ground by a cop.
Oh, no.
Handcuffed, detained.
For recording?
For a period of time. For simply recording.
Wow.
Before they found I had broken no laws and they let me go. I have filed a lawsuit on that. But
yes.
That particular incident has spawned like this big controversy in my own family.
Oh, no.
Where they see me as this
troublemaker,
lunatic, or a troublemaker.
Rabble rouser.
Who should just obey the police and not cause any problems. And I'm sitting here looking around, thinking I was a victim.
Which family? Just to clarify, are we talking about immediate family, mom, dad, brother, sister? Are we talking about cousins?
Immediate family, and also some friends have reached out to me like I have a problem or a drug addict or something. I'm sitting here we're so far apart on ideology, and it's caused quite the stir in my own family. And so I was curious to you guys who have been on the trail for a while. Have you had any issues with personal relationships since you've became, in the spotlight?
Oh, wow. Well, I mean, my family is diametrically opposed to me politically.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, my father thinks that FDR was the greatest president in history.
Oh, wow.
And seconded by Lincoln. So that's his token Republican, I guess. But they've actually come to where they respect what I'm doing and they understand what I'm doing, but that's taken a lot of time. And it doesn't happen for everybody. But I've definitely had people that I've been interested in dating who have been like, you might go to jail at any time, so I might not do that.
What about you, Danica? What about your family?
It's been kind of, it's interesting. My parents are pretty diehard Republicans, I guess, but over the years with the whole corruption with government and the police state, they've call themselves more so minarchists because they do feel that there is some sort of need for government, but they think that total anarchy would just be way too chaotic and awful. So
anarchy is not chaos.
I know, exactly. And I keep trying to talk to them about it, but they think that some of the views that I have are a little bit too extreme, but they, for the most part, whenever I talk to them about certain things, they tend to agree with me more rather than try and argue and say, but cops are good and our military is needed. And it's just like, no, it's not.
So it sounds like you probably have the best relationship as far as them, your parents agreeing of the three of us. My dad, he's kind of on board with the liberty thing, but he's not willing to do anything about it because my mom is not. And so she sort of controls that interaction, I guess. He and I used to be in the Libertarian Party in Florida together, and then he changed into a Republican or back into a Republican after, I guess, getting persuaded, let's say, from my mother in that particular case. And my mom's the kind of lady who, based on the conversations I've had with her, I believe she would turn me in if she knew that that I had some marijuana or something like that.
Oh, really?
So, yeah.
Nobody tell Ian's ma.
Yeah.
Sorry, Mom.
is your disagreement with your family, Brett, only on the issue of the police, or has that expanded into a larger discussion about voluntarism, libertarianism, that kind of thing?
Well, I've been preaching to them, for the last, since I've kind of woken up here, and my dad's really responsive. He agrees with, basically everything I say, and he's came around, but my mom is just so old fashioned. Doesn't appreciate me going and challenging authority.
Let's talk about it a little more. If you want, you can stick with us for it, Brett. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. You want to talk about your family interactions? Maybe you've got some suggestions for Brett. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live. We've got time for you.
For P150, P150GA, P150OK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away, so you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
If you're like me, you're concerned about the stock market and the economy. You're asking the questions, but it just doesn't seem that you're getting the right answers. Well, my friends at the Wealth Preservation Institute not only have the answers, but they've put together a free report, How to Survive the Upcoming Economic Collapse and Protect Your 401ks, IRA Savings, and Retirement Income. Don't hesitate. This report's for free for a limited time by calling 888-772-2929. That's 888-772-2929. Take back your financial lives today.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. The remaining moments happening now. You can join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm with you tonight. Ian here.
Danica.
Rich Paul.
Let's go back to Brett. He is in Dallas and has been getting into it with his family members about the issue of police corruption and violence and such, libertarianism in general. And you said your dad, he's kind of cool with it, but mom is not so much. She's not a fan of what you've been doing, trying to hold the police accountable. You got arrested recently. Ultimately, the charges were dropped, though. Is that right?
Yeah, it was more of a catch-and-release scenario where they detained me for like half an hour and then just let me go.
They wanted to get you out of the way. They wanted to arrest. This is common with the police, where they will arrest somebody and then ultimately not charge them or drop the charges later, simply to get you out of their hair and get you out of a scene.
Now, logically, if you win your lawsuit, your family should change sides, because then the court is acknowledging that the police were wrong. So, I don't know, that might come in handy for you later.
That would be nice, but it's more of a disappointment that I'm sensing from my, like, my mother and my sister, where they think that, you know, what I'm doing is wrong, when in fact I believe I'm standing up for what is right. And it just creates an awkward situation between family members, and I just kind of wanted to, you know, basically warn anybody thinking about doing activism that it could, you know, create some awkward situations between, like, friends, family, coworkers, and that kind of thing. So
absolutely.
Certainly,
it's
good. Yeah.
It's something to think about. It's not, you know, it's nothing that's going to be massively affecting my life. But
so I think a factor here, at least this is what I believe to be the case, moms are pretty protective, just generally, right? They love their kids, and they want what's best for their kids, and in their opinion, a protective kind of parent, like a mom in a lot of cases, would see challenging the police as not what's best for their kids, right? Like, you know, going up and recording and, you know, demanding your rights from the police and recording and holding them accountable for their actions is going to get them. And realistically, you know, you do it enough times, there's a good chance some cop's going to target you for it, and you're going to get arrested and charged with some BS, trumped up charges, and sometimes they'll drop the charges, sometimes they won't. Our friend James Cleveland is going to court next month here in Keene for recording the police in a situation wherein they have not dropped the charges, and they're going to a jury trial in this particular case. So you lucked out, Brett. But from a mother's perspective, if you think about it this way, you know, she just wants to see you safe, and she knows that the police are dangerous. She knows they're going to hurt you. So,
and certainly
it's
they're not
safe.
Yeah, and they're not going to want to see you in any sort of incarceration. So, of course, they're more than likely going to say, oh, you know, look, hear out the plea deal, take the plea deal.
Yeah, of course they will.
The other thing I did with my parents that helped maintain peace is I stopped trying to convince them.
Yep.
Because they're 85 years old. They're not going to change their mind. So, and I love my parents and I want to spend time with them. So I try to avoid the subject of politics.
So
I'm
do
there.
I. That's what it's come to for me too, because if it comes up, it'll just escalate, because, you know, I have my beliefs and she has hers, which are really unformed and clueless. But ultimately it doesn't lead to productive conversation between the two of us. It just leads to me being frustrated and her likely feeling similarly. I think it does come from that motherly instinct of, look, son, just obey, just go along to get along so you can keep coming home for Thanksgiving. Yeah. I mean, that's really what it comes down to.
Yeah, what am I going to tell your other family members that, oh, my son's in jail? Like, how's that going to look on you?
Yep, I guess I understand where she's coming from and why. It creates an awkward setting. And, you know, and activism does that. And I just thought I would get your guys' opinion.
Thanks, Brett.
And I do appreciate everything you do.
Yeah, man, thanks for the call in tonight. And, of course, I recommend that people who love liberty move to New Hampshire. We've heard from people in Missouri and Texas tonight, and, you know, they've had trouble with the police and they want to record and they want to protect themselves. Up here, it's generally a safe thing, at least in the Keene area, to record the Keene police. They are well-trained.
Camera broken.
Yeah, that's a good term. Yeah, they know what it's like to be recorded. It's not a shock to them when it happens here. You're not going to get tackled for that here. It just doesn't happen like that. Get together with other people who love freedom, who can back you up, who can be there for you. Rich, you had a situation last night. You went out, you took the cruiser, you were just going to grab some food from somewhere, and you called over the two-way. You said you think you were about to get pulled over. I was actually in bed at the time, but I heard the call come through. I went and got my two-way and called back to you.
you know, just to check in to make sure that everything was all right. Turned out they didn't pull you. They were just going, they went a different direction. It wasn't you. They were after. But, you know, to have these methods to reach out and touch other people who care about freedom, who are willing to get active, the more people we get concentrated in one place, the more effective these methods would be. At this point, I was the only person who responded to you, but there have been situations in which someone has called and they have been pulled over, and we've had 8 people come and show up and, you know, at the actual scene of the pullover. I mean, that's a level of support that you're not going to get from your family, and you're not going to get from other activists anywhere else, because there aren't that many libertarian activists to start with.
Mm-hmm. And we're sucking up as many of them as we can.
Exactly. And you know, too bad for the rest of the liberty movements out there. It is true that the Free State Project, to some extent, is like an activist brain drain. I mean, we're getting the best of the best liberty people here in New Hampshire, and more are going to come. The more success that we have, the more libertarians are going to want to move here, because what, you know, at some point, once bad laws continue to stop being passed here in New Hampshire, because we've managed to stop a few really bad ones so far, and more good laws, you know, good statutes are being put on the books. Like, there's going to be a proposal this year to decriminalize sex work for the first time in New Hampshire.
Nice.
That I've ever heard about. And that's being put forward by a Free State Project participant who's been elected to the state house. So we're going to see a lot of cool stuff like that happening here. Eventually, it's going to get to the point where libertarians are going to look at New Hampshire and they would have to be completely ignorant to not think this is the best option out there in the entire world. So go to freestateproject.org. You can learn more about it. Here's somebody else in Texas. Andy is in Texas listening to TuneIn. Hello, Andy.
When you certainly get arrested for the first time, that is kind of a iffy spot because you have no idea what the heck's going to go on. But when you get arrested for the second time and it's for no reason and you try to exercise your rights and they get a little more aggressive with you simply because you're exercising your rights, that's a whole nother story. And that's happened to me about 3 times now. I've gone to jail for absolutely nothing other than saying, no, I don't need to show you my papers. We're not in Nazi Germany. What the hell do you think you're doing?
Oh, wow. You know?
What state are you in?
Texas.
Oh.
Well, no, I'm in Texas now, but this was Washington State. They just decided that, you know what, you got to show me your ID. I didn't do anything wrong. I'm walking away from a bar with my kid. We're walking home. We didn't do anything. We're just walking. 3 unmarked cars and a marked car pull up. Next thing you know, I'm on the hood of the car because I said, hey, we're not in Nazi Germany. I don't have to show you my papers.
Wow.
And you've got guts.
Did you get it on video?
No, I didn't. I didn't have a phone at that time. So. But no, it was just a terrible moment. My son immediately gave his ID to him and stuff, which I thought was kind of lame, you know, stand the ground. But me, I was like, you know, I don't think I have to show my ID here. I mean, this is the Fourth Amendment thing. I didn't do anything wrong. At least tell me what I did wrong. And then if I agree with you, I'll give you my ID. But they were just like, you know, forget it, dude. Get on the car. And he put his hand on his gun and said, look, dude, if you don't start to participate with what we're doing here, things are going to get rough, you know.
Is there a mandate? Now, in some states, there's a requirement. Most of them, as I understand it, this isn't legal advice, but it's my understanding, that you do have to identify yourself when asked by an officer. That doesn't mean you have to carry government ID. It
just
means
you have
to tell them your name and your birth date, basically, if they ask for it.
Well, they didn't even ask me my name. No, they immediately went for the ID. Let me see your ID.
Is that legal in Washington?
Well, to be honest with you, I have no idea.
What happened to the charges that you were hit with?
Well, I got nailed with hindering a police officer and disturbing the peace. But because nobody complained, this was like 2:00 in the morning. Nobody actually complained about the disturbance, so they dropped that. I went to court and they dropped both charges. But the point of the matter was, I was thrown up on the hood of a car, and
in front of your son.
Yeah, and that's not the only time. I mean, I gave a guy a ride to a strip club. And he caused a fight outside and told the cops when they showed up at the fight outside that he was with me. And all I did was give the guy a ride.
Wow.
And these guys threw me, this was Lakewood police, just down from Tacoma, and these guys threw me on the hood of the car again and arrested me. I got 7 days for that, too. So
Andy, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate your story. Wow. There's no shortage of these stories of police abusing their power.
Well, I hope all these people out here that are telling stories of standing up and getting arrested keep standing up. Because
it's all you can do.
At least you can sit in jail with your self-respect.
Yep, that much is certainly true. I wish we had more time for truthvoice.com and their first arrest, the first arrest story, and we don't. But I'll post the whole thing on our Facebook and Twitter so you can take a look at it for yourself. And don't forget to join us here in real life at freestateproject.org. Keenvention, of course, coming up. That's October 30th through November 1st. And don't forget to check out Rich Paul at the Church of the Invisible Hand on Facebook. We'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime. freetalklive.com. Have a great weekend.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $6 lower at $1,147 per ounce. Silver is down 2 cents at $15.18 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $236. The prospect for getting ahead on silver American Eagles looks bad, but we have plenty of spiders, Britannias, and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Seditious Sirens is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, September 25th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.08 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,144 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports over the weekend, local officials reported that Syria's government and al-Qaeda had reached yet another ceasefire in the city of Zabadani and the Idlib villages of Fua and Kafraya. Unlike previous weekend ceasefires, this was to be an open-ended deal. The ceasefire appears to have led to further delay on Thursday, with the two sides agreeing to mutual evacuation from the area. Under the agreement, al-Qaeda will be allowed to withdraw its fighters from Zabani and Idlib, and they'll let some 10,000 civilians from Fua and Kafraya flee from Idlib into governmental territory. Fua and Kafraya are Shiite villages and were left surrounded by al-Qaeda after recent military losses in the province. Zabadani is surrounded by Hezbollah fighters who are trying to drive al-Qaeda out of the area along the Lebanese border. Interestingly, while the agreement effectively turns Zabadani over to the Hezbollah-led forces, it does not allow pro-Syrian militias to withdraw from Fua and Kafraya, meaning the villages will remain under government control, albeit without any civilian population. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com.
UPI reports Republicans in the U.S. House of Representatives will hear a proposal Friday that would strip federal funding for Planned Parenthood, but avoid the government shutdown that looms over the issue, according to sources. House Speaker John Boehner is pitching the strategy, which would fast-track the move against the organization and put it on President Obama's desk without having to risk a shutdown. The strategy will be discussed Friday in a closed-door meeting. Boehner's motive with this strategy is to satisfy the 30 GOP House members who are willing to risk a shutdown if the stripping of Planned Parenthood is not attached to a critical spending bill. However, Bloomberg Politics reported Thursday some in the House may consider challenging Boehner's leadership. The current spending arrangement expires September 30th. The Senate is planning to submit a new spending bill which would fund the government through December 11th. However, analysts say Boehner's plan might not work because Obama would likely veto the bill stripping Planned Parenthood, and Republicans don't have enough votes in the Senate for an override.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a U.S. Border Patrol agent has been indicted for murder in a cross-border shooting of a Mexican teenager in 2012 in what an attorney for the victim's family on Thursday called an unprecedented move. A federal grand jury on Wednesday indicted Agent Lonnie Schwartz for second-degree murder in the October 10, 2012 shooting death of 16-year-old Jose Antonio Elana Rodriguez. Elana Rodriguez was shot through a fence separating the cities of Nogales, Arizona, where Schwartz was on patrol, and Nogales, Mexico, where the teen was walking. Officials have said Ilana Rodriguez was throwing rocks over the border fence at the agents. He was shot multiple times in the back, according to Louis Parra, an Arizona attorney who is representing the family in a civil suit filed last year. Parra said to his knowledge it was unprecedented for a Border Patrol agent to be charged with murder in a cross-border shooting. He said Schwartz has since been suspended without pay and ordered to turn in his weapon and his badge. Attorney Sean Chapman, who is representing Schwartz, was unavailable for comment on Thursday. Representatives for U.S. Customs and Border Protection could not be immediately reached. A union representing Border Patrol agents across the western United States spoke out against the charges on Thursday in a post on the union website. The union asked that the public withhold judgment while the criminal case plays out and said Schwartz is innocent. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Following morning reports indicating that Philadelphia High School for the Performing Arts student Samantha Bylum deals with really weird social pressures on a daily basis, Onion reporters met with the 16-year-old dance student who described feeling regularly alienated from her peers for extremely bizarre reasons.
If you're not up to date on the latest urban street art or Esperanza Spalding albums, the other students will eat you alive. It can get pretty brutal. Just the other day, everyone cut class to go watch the Million Dollar Quartet musical at the Forest Theater, but nobody told me. Now I'm the only one that hasn't seen Lance Guest's rendition of Folsom Prison Blues. It's humiliating.
According to Bylum, the school year shows no sign of letting up as she continues dealing with the everyday stresses of auditioning for the school's production of My Fair Lady, keeping up with the latest punk Afrofusion dance groups, and not having enough fishnet sleeves to wear throughout the week.
Honestly, I don't know how the other students deal with it.
Keep checking TheOnion.com for more as this story develops.
This is the Onion News Network.
And welcome to Seditious Sirens.